Scriptures talk about a blessedness that happens to a man whose delight is in the law of God. So as someone says, it says, but his delight is in the law of God, and doth he meditate day and night. He says that that man is like a tree planted by the rivers of water, whose leaves do not wither, and who bears fruit in every season. As you are about listening to this message, we believe that your life is going to be like that man planted by the rivers of water. Your leaves are forever going to bear. And we know that your season will not pass by. You will forever shine and you will forever bear fruit. We have a lot of content to share with you. So we would entreat you to subscribe to this channel, as well as like us. Hit that notification bell to receive more updates from us, because we know that whatever content here is going to set you on course at every time. It's going to make you attain whatever stature that Christ wants you to attain. Thank you.
The wisdom of God can turn any man who believes it and walks in that reality into a sign and a wonder. Hallelujah. And I sincerely believe with all my heart that that is why we are here. I come here because I recognize my need for wisdom. I recognize that it is only in His presence, and only when His word is accurately communicated, the principles of the word are accurately communicated, not the information. The information has no power to produce change. You see, let me tell you something. When people do not have faith, it is not because they do not believe God. There is a level of accuracy with which the word of God was designed to be communicated. And if that word is communicated properly, there is a spiritual logic to it that becomes the basis upon which the faith of the people are grounded. Paul said, when I came to you, I did not come with the excellency of speech, he says, but in the demonstration of power, that your faith will not be grounded upon the wisdom of men, Sophia, wisdom that is a product of education, experience, that is limited, suggestions of men, opinions that were based on a very short view. But the Bible says, forever, O Lord, thy word is settled. It never said it's settled in the earth, it's settled in heaven. It takes doing what heaven has done to make the word settle in our lives. In the name of Jesus. So I welcome everyone. Thank you for coming, as always. Those following us online, thousands of people, we love you, we honor you. Let your hearts be open. Let your spirits be open. For those coming here for the first time, this is Koinonia. And we're on a series, Thrive Part 2. T-H-R-I-V-E. This is Part 2. The series is an attempt to concretize upon our hearts some of the keys that are required for transgenerational relevance. Some of the keys that are required for rising above the vicissitudes of life. Like I said last week, it will be irresponsible to pretend that the economic turmoil, the hardship, and all of the things that people are going through is not telling on people. You cannot imagine the stories that have emerged as a result of people's frustration. Whenever a people are limited in any way, it will only take time, they will react. And oftentimes, they will react based on the informations that they have. So they will use violence, they would do a lot of very stupid things. I've heard of people walking naked for money. I've heard of people giving their children for all kinds of immoral things for money. I've heard of people doing all sorts of things. And the truth about it is that except you are shielded with revelation, you will really feel the gravity of what is happening. Institutions are lamenting, churches are lamenting, social organizations, businesses lamenting, The government itself is lamenting, and that means that we have to source for light and life from another dimension, another reality that is beyond the scope of the human experience. Amen. And I started sharing with us last week how that it is possible to rise above these things. I love the song that the worship team communicated. There is victory. Listen. There is no experience of anyone, regardless of what the peculiar experience is, that is worthy enough to disprove the power, the integrity, the glory, and the efficacy of the person and the word of God. Are we together? If I die today of sickness, my dying of sickness will raise a lot of questions among those who love me, those connected to this vision, and several people across the world. But it does not change the fact that God is mighty and it is within his power to heal. Are we together? If you really want to receive from God, you must desist from isolating your singular experience and using it as a template to judge everything the Bible says about God. Because our experiences are limited. The Bible says that we see in part, 1 Corinthians 13. We see in part, therefore we prophesy. Our communications and that which we do is according to our perspectives. This is why I seek him as a matter of life and death. Let it not be that I'm holding on to a perspective that after many years of being convicted by it and leading others to be convicted by it, I discover that I have lived in error and have communicated the same to people. The Bible says that we be careful so that what we call light be not darkness. After many years of a man's life, you can discover that the very foundation upon which your convictions are built upon is wrong, inaccurate, imbalanced. Are we together? So when we come before his presence, our hearts must be opened. You don't come to God with an opinion, hoping that he agrees with you. When you come to him, your heart is absolutely open. You say, Lord, I am aware of my vulnerability. I'm a product of culture. I'm a product of genetic programming. I'm a product of environmental conditioning. And many of the realities that I've held as true, though popular, though spiritual, may not be consistent with your path. So I come to you with every open-heartedness, trusting that you will build, you will tear down, you will rearrange and bring order to my life. And that's what God is doing in the name of Jesus. Every time you see consistent results in the life of a man, in the life of a people, in the life of a territory, it is because there is something that is done correctly. Whether or not the practitioners are aware of the dynamics of what they are doing. Are we together? Whether or not the individuals can explain in detail what they are doing or not. The moment you see consistent results, regardless of limitations, there are laws, there are principles that are being practiced. Are we together? And I'm going to take it from there. I shared with us a few things, 4 points in all. We took two. I'll begin to take from where we left off last week, and then we'll continue. Number one, I told us that the key to rising above the vicissitudes of life, rising above the challenges and the things that hold men crippled spiritually, economically, and so on and so forth, the first key is a genuine encounter with Jesus Christ. The first key to becoming relevant is not being educated. The first key to becoming relevant is not having business acumen. It's not even being a leader. Are we together? It's not any of these things. Success and any kind of impact, a life of notable impact, starts from the health and the quality of a man's spiritual life. Say amen. The measure of your impact through God in the kingdom is directly associated with the genuineness of your hunger, the sincerity of your love for God. While we're away on a ministration in the course of the week, I met a man of God who was at the meeting, and he just came to see me and talk to me, and you know, God did great things and honored himself in the meeting. And the man sat down and he began to weep like a baby, and he said, "Sir, what is the secret?" I don't know how many times people have asked this, "What is the secret?" And I kept looking at him and I said, "Sir, I can bet that you might be disappointed if I tell you. I wish the secret were just fasting and prayer. I wish the secret were just the quality of my word study life. I wish the secret were just that I was anointed." As important as those things are, I told him, "If you want me to be sincere with you and you have the heart to receive, the secret to the dimensions that by the grace of God I've been able to access," are we together, "is tied primarily to my passion for God and my sincere desire to see him glorified. My passion for God and my sincere desire to see him glorified." You've heard me say it, and God knows my heart. I love God more than ministry. I love God more than money. I love God more than anointing. I don't use him for these things. Never have and never will. I'd rather give up ministry 1,000 times to remain in his presence and to remain in love with him. I even love him more than the quest for his presence. This is where I believe many people miss it, because primarily our motives are corrupted. God for us means many things. For other people, he's just a solution, like a charm, like a genie that you use and invoke his name, invoke his blood, invoke his fire, invoke whatever to get results. You're not going to really host extraordinary results that way. Are we together? A genuine encounter with Jesus that births the fear of God in you, that births love for God and love for humanity. It's not enough to love God. You must love the people he has sent to you. And you must love the body. I love the body of Christ with all my heart. I am part of it. I'm proud to be part of it. I love the body of Christ. I may not agree with every perspective in the body of Christ. I may not hold as part of my conviction every opinion and perspective, but it's too little a reason to not love the body of Christ. I love the body of Christ, regardless of man of God, regardless of denomination, regardless of exploits or setbacks. I genuinely love the body of Christ. Now, let me tell you, when you get to this spiritual state, when you can assume this posture, you are ready to host the grace for transgenerational relevance. Not outside of this condition. The Bible says, "No eye has seen, no ear has heard, neither has it come into the heart of any man that which God has in store, not for them that pray, not for them that seek him, for them that love him." When a man truly falls in love with God and is addicted with his presence, his life, everything about God becomes an obsession to you. His house, his life, his word, everything, your whole life is poured as a drink offering. Then you are ready to rise above any challenge. I'm telling you, challenges will come upon you. You will rise and shake them off as if they do not exist. Believe me, I know what I'm saying. Are we together? So we discussed that. And I said how that many believers, they may be born again, but they've not had a genuine encounter with Jesus. An encounter that is greater than any circumstance. You know, when people doubt God and turn and insult God to his face over situations and circumstances, "Lord, I prayed for tea, you didn't give me tea. I prayed for bread, you didn't give me bread. I prayed for CGPA, I prayed for a job, you are not faithful. And you know, God, if you don't do this, I will backslide." It's because you've not had an encounter. The remedy for that kind of talk is just an encounter. It's not counseling. The remedy is an encounter. There is a way that a man encounters God that you owe him your allegiance regardless of what happens around your life. Are we together? It's very important. Whether you bless me or not, I'm in love with you to a point of addiction. Whether ministry rises or not, it has no, it does not contribute in any way to influencing my love and my appetite for you. Please, I pray that as you listen to me, this will become a reality. That this will not just become a talk from a preacher. You see, when you are pretending certain things in the kingdom, it will only take time. Time does not change anything, but time is a revealer of motives. Time will reveal whether you genuinely love God or not. The second thing we said that is the key, and I'll pick up from here now, that's where we left off last week, is the power of mental transformation. The second key that is required to rise above and beyond the challenges in life, listen please, to rise above the limitations that plague mankind, to rise to a life that is of notable transgenerational relevance, a degree of kingdom impact that outlives you if Christ tarries, the power of mental transformation. Listen, I said it never tires me to communicate to God's people the extent to which the quality of their paradigm can determine the course of their future in ministry, in life, in business, in marriage, in any area at all. The quality of your mindset. Are we together? And I told us last week that we are conditioned in two ways, basically. The first condition is a genetic programming. We are programmed genetically by reason of the transfer of traits. I'm being very slow and being very detailed because I want us to get this. The second, which is the most disastrous or most notable of the transformations, is environmental programming. Say environmental programming. We are programmed environmentally, which can be engineered by culture, past experiences, our levels of exposure, the environment that we grew up in. Chances are that if you never saw a successful person growing up, you do not have a reference. You see, belief is based on a reference. Are we together? You cannot believe vaguely. There must be a reference, preferably a physical living reference that becomes a standard and the platform upon which your convictions are built. This is why the disciples were very powerful. Jesus was a reference. And that's why every leader that must teach people, part of the assignment of every leader is not only to communicate his persuasions, but to be a reference of the same. It is easy for people to believe when there is a measure, when a leader is in different ways reference worthy, it becomes easy for individuals to connect. When a man is teaching about the anointing and there is some degree of the demonstration of the power and the grace of God upon his life, it becomes easy for the listeners to be persuaded by that dimension. Are we together? It is very difficult. Listen, it is very difficult to persuade people over a reality that your life cannot be a reference of. No matter how little the reference is, that it is worthy of conviction. The same thing I am teaching now, I am going to be teaching it 10, 15 years to come. But it will be more impactful than it is now, because by that time my life will be a higher reference than it is now. The same way some of the things I'm sharing now were the things that I shared a number of years past, but their impact were not as impactful as it is now. Of course, I've grown in the anointing, but also there have been maybe a few evidences here and there that can back up and support that communication. Communicating a dimension of spiritual reality or a dimension of any reality that does not have your life as a commendable reference is very frustrating. This already is a lesson for someone, that if you want to change your world, the first key is to change yourself. That you become a template enough. People are not that hardened. People are only obsessed with results. It is God that sees the heart. Men look at the outward appearance. They want to see that if you are teaching on divine health, there is a measure of that reality at work in you. If you are teaching on kingdom wealth and prosperity, there is a measure of that reality. If you are teaching on leadership or excellence or dimensions of kingdom reality, there is a level of persuasion that stems from your own experience. Are we blessed tonight? The power of mental transformation. The Bible says in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 9, it says, receiving the end of your faith. We discussed that last week. It said, even the salvation of your soul. The salvation of your soul. Bringing your soul through the renewal of your mind to a point where it can host the realities that are resident within your spirit. I began to discuss with us, and we've done this over different series as we've discussed through the years, the power of paradigms. Look at me. Listen, let me tell you something. As great as a man is, he can limit God. Remember our scripture that has become an anthem in this place, Psalm 78 verse 41. They limited the Holy One. They limited the Holy One. They limited the Holy One. They said, can God make a table in the wilderness? They limited the Holy One. It was not their fault. It was their conditioning. After 430 years of servitude with no hope of deliverance, it was understandable that such a people as a corporate entity can doubt God. Something about our culture, as good as it is, something about our cultural experiences have informed us, has created an understanding in our minds. I was talking to a dear friend today who came over to see me, and we were discussing certain things. He was along the side of the line of marriage and all of that. And I was sharing with him, generally speaking, we got into different discussions, and I was telling him that if I were to counsel an intending couple, I'm not going to waste time asking a lot of useless and vague questions. The first thing I want to examine is their passion for God. And then the next thing, I want to examine the extent of their compatibility in terms of their understanding. What is your viewpoint about God? What is your viewpoint about money? What is your viewpoint about your assignment and purpose? What is your viewpoint about your personal life? What is your viewpoint about external influences in your life and home? This does not just apply to the line of marriage, it applies to everything. There is something culture taught us about God. There is something our well-meaning pastors and preachers told us about God. Their experiences were their sermons. They preached it with confidence. We embraced it with sincerity. And we are victims of their limitations. Are we together? There's something that our past experiences have done. I always give an example. If it took someone 10 years to get admission, and you teach on favor, it will take an extra anointing for that person to understand that message. Are we together? Because there is no template that represents favor in his life. Most of our families live from hand to mouth. So every time we talk about prosperity, our minds go straight to the people they insulted and the way they insulted them. We have associated prosperity with negativism, with fraud, with unseriousness, with fetish, demonic activities, especially when young people are prosperous. And let me tell you something. After listening to a very powerful message, after listening to a powerful series, Financial Dominion, The Wealthy Place, The Economic System of the Kingdom, you will think that your paradigm will change at once. No, it took a long time for it to be built. It will take a repetition of new ideas are the keys to changing our paradigms. You have to bring forth those new ideas again and again. That's why the Bible says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing, the next word hearing there is understanding. Hearing and understanding what you hear by the word of God. Hallelujah. Proverbs tells us, For as he thinketh in his heart, it didn't say so he will become. It didn't say so he is becoming. For as he thinketh in his heart, so is he. For as he thinketh in his heart, it equates my physical reality to my life. This is the difference, hear me brothers and sisters, between a CEO who is living in an office with an AC, having secretaries and PAs, and sitting down, and you think he's just writing, and then a megad, a security person who is opening and closing gates in anger and frustration. Most times a security person is angry. How can I be working so hard and I'm receiving 10,000 per month, and someone is there just writing and he's receiving 500,000? And my answer to that frustration is what? Switch them for only 2 weeks. Take the megad. Don't change anything. Don't give him any orientation. Keep him in that office and take the CEO to the gate. Let me tell you what will happen after 2 weeks. People will stop going to the office. The CEO will do something to that gate that will make the customers remain there. Are we together? His hospitality, his open-heartedness, his calmness, his people skills, and all of these other factors that are important for success will compel the people to love him and remain there. Let's go to our man in the office. I know what he will be doing. Drinking all the juice in the fridge as fast as he can, because something about his mind tells him you are certainly not going to be here for a long time. Then he looks for what to steal. He signs documents anyhow, and then he crosses his leg watching TV, changing channels, enjoying the AC, probably texting all the people and say, my life has changed. The place will be dirty. I assure you, he will not empty the waste bin. He doesn't have that frame of excellence. His paradigm of excellence is not that way. He will destroy everything. He will misplace documents, scatter them, and wonder why they are arranged accurately. At the end of it, he will be frustrated. He will steal something sizable and run away. That will be the end of that man. Another popular example. You wore a shirt for 1 year. It was always clean and ironed. Nobody knew it was 1 year old. And you gave somebody, and his mindset rubbed off on the shirt. In 1 month, he turned a white shirt to brown. Have you seen people like that? Yeah. Listen, our physical environment is but a looking glass. You never change your physical reality by arguing and trying to change things. It's not even by trying to dress well. No. It's a culture. You've got to change your mind. So the Bible says in Philippians chapter 2 from verse 5, permit this mind to be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. I was not born this way. I re-engineered myself using the word of God and following those who through faith and patience have obtained the promise. Are we together? You must be disloyal to any understanding and paradigm that has given demon spirits access points to destroy your life. Hallelujah. Paradigms. There are people who will use a water system toilet, a very clean toilet, and finish. I mean, in a house, not even the one in the hostels. A clean toilet. They enter the bathroom, they saw everything clean. They use it and leave it there and just go out smiling. And they tell you, I've finished. They took their mindsets there. Their mindsets took them there. Are we together? Yeah. There is something about excellence, as obvious as it should be, you must be trained to discern it. Don't ever assume that because your mindset has changed, it is so. That's the reason why the higher you rise, the more you must have a greater capacity for patience. Because when your mindset changes, you wonder. Sometimes I look at people and I am amazed the way they think. Certain things that should be so obvious, you are wondering how their mindset can veer off and give them such suggestions. The power of paradigms. Are we together? A man can come to you. Someone can come to a Jimmy, for instance, and sit down and look at him and look at his house and see how God has blessed him. And then just look at him and say, sir, don't be offended. Anything for the boys? And you are wondering. You have access to a great man. What is there to say, sir? If you were to be at my age, what will you advise me to do? Or if you will be at my level in life, what two things do you think I should focus on now? We never ask questions. Have you seen people who have access to great men? One guy came to my hotel room in Abuja, and he came just because of his friend. He wouldn't even come. He came there because of someone like a mentor to him, who is my friend. They came to greet me. When they said hello, we're discussing, I served them myself. I'm telling you, before anybody picked the thing, the guy carried the something and opened it and was taking it. Whereas the person, his mentor, now kept quiet and was listening. You see why that guy is his mentor? Are we together? There is a logic to people's frustration. You can trace it and see why they are where they are. Paradigms, mindsets. Why should I dress well? Am I rich? Paradigm. Are we together? There are people praying endlessly to have pot belly, just like that. Why? Because based on certain cultural experiences. Now listen, I'm not being sarcastic. I'm teaching here. There are cultures, am I right, that train people. The moment they see you with some level of weight, they say, things are working. But you know that absolutely nothing is working. Paradigms. That's what informs people to live fake lives. There are people who, if God blesses with 50,000 now, their mindset tells them, look, you need to do something around you to make people believe you belong. So they run away and blow up everything, and they come to people. And you see, sometimes, let me tell you something. When I meet people who are greater than me, I have no pressure to prove any point, because I know I'm stupid when I'm doing it. But then you see a lot of people with their little understanding, small results here and there, they come and they never learn. They are trying to impress you. Hey, Jimmy, I'm a business person. I just read Robert Kiyosaki's book, and you are watching his ignorance. That act alone is a revelation of where you are. Because great people are silent. Let her works speak for her at the gates. And so when we're done, let me finish up my story. They were about to go. I was greeting them, you know. And then the gentleman just came to me and said, sir, please, just one favor. I said, what is it? He said, let me snap with you. And I looked at him. I said, this boy is not wise, honestly speaking. That's why we must crave for wisdom. I said, this guy is not smart one bit. I said, all right, that's okay. He snapped with me. About 3 hours later, my friend called me and said, the guy posted the picture on Facebook that me and my very good friend, Apostle Joshua Selman. Now, hold on. I'm not insulting him. He may even be listening now. Listen. Do you know that gentleman thinks it's by snapping with me so that every other person around, look, let me tell you, if a billionaire wears slippers and kaftan and you wear suit and stand close to him, something about you will tell you are not yet ready for this place. If Benny Hinn stands today and I side by side with him and they say colleagues in ministry, even me, I know, God knows, the devil knows that we are not colleagues. They will snap me standing. When you watch the picture, I will be kneeling down. Because the reality of my heart will reflect itself. Amen. Say paradigms. Say mindsets. Say programmings. Something that your parents held was responsible for their limitations, culture, experiences. Are we together? I don't want to be ahead of myself, because the third thing I'll be talking about is where we'll dwell today in details. And I trust that God will change our mindsets. Now, let me tell you something. There is nothing God can do about your life, as powerful as He is, if you are not willing to change your mindset. Lord, I want you to bless me. And God says, okay, can you allow me to walk on you? There's nothing wrong with me. God says, all right. There is a mindset that is responsible for poverty. There is a mindset that has kept many men of God limited in life and ministry. There are certain mindsets that have kept corporate organizations small. Sometimes I wish that I knew the things I've learned in the last 2-3 years, maybe that I knew them 10-20 years ago. I would have been 100 times, without exaggerating, higher than I am now. I pray that you will receive these things and you will believe them. In 1 minute, lay your hand on your head and say, Lord, there is something in my mind that is responsible for my limitations. Please take it out of me. Go ahead and pray. Take it out of me. Take it out of me. There's something. I grew up in Nigeria, and there is a way. Nigerians are lovely people. They are great people. But there is a faulty paradigm. Take it away from my life. Take it away from my life. I declare my disloyalty to every paradigm, no matter how long I have held it. A paradigm that has stopped me from accessing the anointing. A paradigm that has stopped me from being a leader. A paradigm that has stopped me from being a visionary person. A paradigm that has stopped me from being wealthy. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. All right, so let's take today's own. The third key. Key number three to rising above recession. Key number three to rising above any kind of limitation is the discovery and the development of your value and your abilities. I'm going to dwell here. There is a lot to talk about here. The discovery and the development of your abilities, your value. I've done a lot of teachings, and I have taught again and again how that a man's relevance, please listen to me, a man's relevance is not based on chance, is not based on some kind of sentiments. The disparity, the stratification between the wealthy, between the great, the anointed, the influential, among many other reasons, primarily is their value. Write this down, please. Your value is a representation of your worth. Your value is a representation of your worth. W-O-R-D. Your value is a representation of your worth. Based on the solutions you provide, the problems you solve, and the lives you transform. Your value is a representation of your worth. Based on the solutions you provide, the problems you solve, and the lives you transform. This is the index for measuring a man's value. So when we say a person is valuable, a preacher is valuable, a businessman is valuable, a leader is valuable, please listen to me. We're not necessarily just talking about anything vague or anything fetish. A measure of the perception that people have over you on the strength of the solutions that you provide, on the strength of the problems that you solve, and on the strength of the lives and destinies that you transform. Put it in another way, if you are not providing any kind of solution, if you are not solving any kind of problem, and if you are not contributing to the transformation of the lives and destinies of people, you are not valuable. And hear me, please. Relevance and wealth in the kingdom is built on a reward system. We've said it again and again. Let me just do a recap on it. I'll touch a bit into that. Right? You can get the message, the wealthy place. Write this down. This is the fundamental law that governs wealth and abundance and governs greatness in the kingdom. Our rewards in life, and that reward can be financial, the sense of security, the sense of honor that we receive, whatever it is, our rewards in life will always be in exact proportion to number one, the demand or the need for what we do. Number one, the demand or the need for what we do. Number two, our ability to do what we do. Number three, the difficulty in replacing us. My relevance in life, my relevance as a man of God is not just tied to God. The demand for what I do, my ability to do what I do, and the difficulty in replacing me. Let me tell you, when you understand this, you can accurately gauge why you are where you are right now. This is why pastors are wealthy. Listen, pastors think they are wealthy. I was teaching the school of ministry, students, and I said many men of God think they are rich because they are serving God. That's not the reason why people are wealthy. It's based on a law. If I am blessed today, among other reasons, is based on the perception that you and other people around this nation and in certain parts of the world have about me, which is on the strength of what I do, my proficiency in doing it. Are we together? A man of God is not rich because he prayed for the sick. A man of God is rich because he's providing solutions. His solution may be supernatural in origin. The solution may be spiritual. When you connect people to Jesus Christ, you are providing an eternal solution to the predicament of men. And the system of God's economy was designed that every time you dispense value, whether given for free or sold, a reward must come to you. A reward must come to you. The laws are inflexible. You cannot change them. So for as long as there is an anointing upon me to bring people to the place of encounter, for as long as there is an anointing upon me to birth transformation of the minds and destinies, for as long as there is an anointing to birth revival, to bring miracles, signs and wonders, I remain valuable as far as God is concerned and the benefactors. Let me tell you why that is powerful. Much more than business, it is an intrinsic value. Value that is not dependent on any external environment, and value that is rewarded only based on the perception of the benefactors. So one person can bless me with 100 naira as a representation of his comprehension of my value. Another person can bless me with 10 million as his comprehension of the perception of my value. Don't say I am poor. Don't say I am mediocre. What value are you bringing to the table of destiny? Call this stage the table of greatness. There are enough seats for everyone, but your pass is your value. Your pass is your value. Not just any value. Values that are needed and useful. Values that are needed and useful, applicable to the predicament of your generation. God is helping someone. Are we together? What have you brought to the table of greatness that author? You know, listen. Do you know why they call people thieves and fraud? Because you see rewards, but you do not see the value that is commensurate to that reward. That's why we hate armed robbers. An armed robber brings a gun and says, give me your 1 million. And you tell him, what is the value? He says, I have no value, but I have a gun to threaten you. So it is bad. But that same 1 million, you will give it to someone who offers a value that is worth it. Listen, you don't sit down and wish to rise. You grow in value to the level that matches what you desire. So, Frank Edward ministers, and based on the perception of his value, someone can bless him with 10 million. Whereas there is another musician somewhere in Samaru who may be moving around and nobody will bless him. What is the difference? Their value. Your value is a representation of your worth based on your ability. There are two dimensions to value. I want to talk a bit about value. Number one is intrinsic value. Write it down. Intrinsic or inherent value. Value that came with you. It was a gift from God to you. Part of your packaging and part of your wiring. It can be improved upon. Hallelujah. Are we blessed this night? I really want to challenge you. Look at me, please. Please do not trivialize what I'm teaching you. God is not a herbalist. This is the key that lifts men above recession. I was talking to one of our ladies. She works in the bank. And I was talking to her this morning. And I told her, I said, how is it going in the bank? And she said, Kai, things are really bad for many people, though. But she said, there are some. I said, that's right. In my mind, I said, that's me. You are now talking about me. He said, there are some, their lives have increased and multiplied. Do you know the concept of recession is not supposed to apply to an individual? Recession only makes sense when you look at it from a corporate and a territorial perspective. There was famine in Samaria minus the king. Minus the king. Number two, minus Elijah. All the people, Elijah never said, please. Even Elijah begged for bread. Elijah did not beg for bread in Samaria. He came gallantly and saw people eating their children. The other one said, we ate my child yesterday. We said, let's boil this other child, and the woman refused. Are we together? Prophet, we boiled my child yesterday. When I was eating my child, we ate together. Now is the turn to eat her own child, and they refused. And the prophet said, no. Let me tell you something. Your value vetoes your education. Your value vetoes your cultural background. Your value vetoes any limitation. I don't care what it is. Will you open up the gates? Open up the doors. Will you open up the gates? Open up the doors. Listen, believe me, brothers and sisters, when I tell you your value vetoes a lot of things. Sunday Adelaja, 96% of his membership in a communist nation. Right? Ukraine, a communist nation, 96% of its members are white. In a communist nation. Value. The key to eradicating a sense of unworthiness is not criticizing great people. This is what a lot of pastors go through. This is what a lot of business people go through. This is what a lot of individuals go through. They think the key is resentment and anger and hatred. No, the key is to pay the price of discovery and developing your value. A student comes in, backtrack 5 years, 6 years, a naive young person, probably in his teenage, comes into an institution. I want to study medicine. Not even having an idea of what he wants to do. Are we together? Or the implication. And he goes through 5, 6, probably 7 years of rigorous training. They never change his skin. They never change his clothes. They only change his mind. And after 6, 7 years, a panel of people will test him and accredit the fact that he is worthy of being called a doctor, and they issue a little piece of paper that becomes his authorization. Value. I am surprised when many people say, why am I poor? What kind of question is that? Why am I poor? Why am I suffering the recession? And I mean no disrespect as I communicate this. Everyone is left to his lot. If Bill Gates, for instance, let me use finances. If Bill Gates comes here right now and says, everybody, Go and hold someone whose life you changed. If you can hold 5 people, you receive $1 million. Some of us will roam to everybody. You touch somebody, you say, I will slap you. You've not added any value to my life. Why do you have to hold me? I have never been blessed, not by your wisdom, not by your spiritual life, not by your anointing, not by your academics. Nothing about you has changed me. But there are others, there will not be enough room. Everybody says, he changed me. You changed me. You blessed me. You advised me. My business is flourishing because of the idea you gave me. That sickness in my body left because of the anointing upon your life. The power of your secret place changed my life. You preached a message and brought a dimension that changed me. Problem solved. Solutions provided. Lives transformed. And there is a reward waiting for you. I guarantee you. No witch and no wizard from any village and anywhere has the power and the capacity to stand an individual that has walked upon his value. What is my value? What is my gift? What is that ability that can bail me out? Let me tell you something. And I'm a Nigerian. I want to say something that is very serious right now. I'm a Nigerian. I love Nigeria. I love everyone in this country. We are brothers and sisters. Are we together? But listen, do you know why? I want to be sincere with you. Do you know why a lot of people are suffering this recession now? I know many people think it's Buhari. Others think it's Jonathan. Other people think it's PDP, APC. I'm not a politician. Are you together? Let me tell you, something about the nose diving of the oil reveal that we have never truly been valuable as a people. We only receive natural resources and we have been covering it for years. The same way to happen to your destiny. I mean, a department, they give everybody food free of charge. So I think, let me tell you, you do not generalize impact and success. You must be sure what part you are contributing. Otherwise, you'll be ashamed with time. We are worship team. We are all great. But in all sincerity, what is your unique contribution? One day you hold the mic alone. And on that day, we know that you are the one limiting the worship team. On that day, we know, so that mistake in the keyboard comes from you. We have been managing it, but right now, we are a group of intelligent lecturers. We are all intelligent people. The day you have to do a presentation as a person, life must single you out one day to defend yourself. I belong to an anointed ministry, great and wonderful. We are shaking the world. I agree with you. A day will come, you will stand before the sick. Apostle, I'm not there. Ejimi, I'm not there. My head of department, prayer, ushering, decoration, they are all not there. On that day, that's when you will know whether the impartations you've been receiving or otherwise. Life will challenge you. Life will test it. And until you are able to prove it, the disciples kept enjoying corporate success until one day when Jesus climbed up the Mount of Transfiguration, they were happy. They brought an epileptic person. They said, don't worry about Jesus. We are here. Just keep him down. They struggled. They were embarrassed. Nothing happened. Let me tell you, do you know what causes jealousy? The ease and the flawlessness that someone who has paid the price to be valuable does on something you have been frustrated about. You've been praying on a sick body and you gave all kinds of reasons. No, this person cannot be sick. Then the person comes for a meeting and even without being prayed for, before the opening prayer, he's healed. And then the person testifies exactly as it happened. You know how people testify? They will say it the way it happened. May God make you to develop an appetite to be valuable. An appetite to be valuable. Let me tell you how you know you are really valuable. When no monetary value placed on you becomes a burden to the giver, you are exceptionally valuable. Listen. I can't remember how much this is, how much they bought it. But let's assume this is 300,000. Just an assumption, right? Assume that this pulpit is 300,000. When they call the price, what do? You look at it. The material, the quality. And you say, it's okay. If they look at this and say, bring 10 million, you look at it and say, no. That's the same way they rate you. So you say 20,000, they say you are telling the truth. Then you say 100,000, they say for where? Is money free like that? But there are others, they don't even say anything. Their value says any amount, priceless, 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 priceless. And so someone brings 10 million and says, sir, please don't be offended. It's a privilege for me to do this. May you be such a person. May you be such a person. Hallelujah. Benny Hinn is coming to Nigeria, and the plans that have, in fact, to a point that the very ministry that is bringing him does not even have absolute control over his coming again. The Christian bodies have had to come in because they sat and said, no, we are going to come in. Now, he's not only ministering in Lagos, he's also going to worry to go and minister in a crusade again. Say value. When Benny Hinn enters a nation, no matter who is inviting him, he is received by the ambassador of the America and a presidential delegation. So his coming is not something you wake up and come by mistake. Even if he's strolling, his personality, we call it human capital. My desire is that under God, myself and this great ministry will be so valuable. This place has become like a place of pilgrimage right now. The protocol has had to start making arrangements with hotels around. Why? Because every week, groups are coming, individuals are coming from all over the nation. It's called value. If we remain at this level, we will never rise. But if we keep rising by the Spirit of God and through determination, a time will come, somebody will come from another state, another nation, and say it's a privilege, finally. Are you that valuable? Are you that valuable that your absence is an interruption to somebody's life? Are you so valuable? I'm speaking to you from the depth of my heart. Then you will know why certain... The money we are saying has left Nigeria did not disappear. Money is like energy. It can neither be created nor destroyed. It is transferred. So it leaves from the point of no value, passes through the place of small value, and lands in the place of capital value. Say amen. Wanting something for nothing is fraud. Wanting something for nothing is wickedness. Now, let me tell you how many of us approach it. Oh God, will you keep looking at me like this? And God says, I've been looking. I set laws and I put preachers. He said, let them come back to life. Remember the prayer of who? The rich man. Let them come back to life. He said, no, they have the prophets and the law. If they will not listen to them, even if somebody comes back to the dead, they will not listen. Just like there are people God has anointed, but many people will not listen. Why should you fail in life? Your background? Who told you it's because of your background? There are people today with no arms, but they are valuable. There are people with no legs, they are valuable. There are people with no eyes, they are valuable. There are people who cannot speak, they are valuable. We don't love Jesus just because he's the Son of God. He's really valuable. He's an expression of infinite value by every standard. Are we together? Any man can determine his lot in life. Any man can determine his lot in life. Your reward is in exact proportion. But apostle, I'm a graduate and now I'm working. I'm getting 50,000. But now I'm married to a wife and three children. That's the limit of your value. Because your education was never designed to fund your assignment. It was designed to help you. You are only working at the limit of what you know. And if you do not know more, you will remain that way. Hallelujah. Yesterday, one of the protocol, he usually helps me if they need to fix anything in my car, he helps me to fix it. And I was going to drop him and I decided to just take a stroll with him. I like talking to people. I decided to take a stroll with him and then to turn and come back. And I was talking to him. I said, do you know why you are in this car now? And he looked at me. I said, there are so many people in Zaria. You can drive and you have loyalty and integrity. It's called value. It earned you the right here. When we stop, let me confess, we went to buy suya. Praise God. And so while they were ordering the suya, I made an order of the suya and he was sitting. I said, do you know why you are sitting close to me now? He said, no, sir. I said, value. You are the one who went to fix the car. It gave you the privilege to do it. I told him, do you know why we are not in the filling station now? He said, no. He said, because the tank is full. The day it finishes or gets more, we will need the filling station. Are we together? Why have I not come to you? Why have I not called you? You don't call me. Why should I? Why should I? You are proving as if I'm nothing. You made yourself so. There is a way you make yourself. There are people who cannot even pick calls. There are others who are angry. Aaron, I don't like what you are doing. Harper, is it because God has lifted you now? You left us. That's always what they say. I intend to rise. Whoever intends to rise with me, then we move together. I cannot love you so much to be so loyal and keep myself low. I'm telling you why many of us are offended with so many people. Offended, my friend. We used to eat together, but you were not doing the same thing. Now the person has risen. You call the person and a secretary picks. Hello, sir, so organization. Please let me talk to him, Jare. Tell him my name is Ajayi. You don't know me again. And you are shouting and raking and getting angry. May God make you so valuable. Listen to me. May God make you so valuable that your value transcends territories. Because there are values that are only, there are people, that's what we call local champion. One who is valuable within a territory. And so when you step out to another territory, you are as inert as somebody whose potential is not at work. But there are certain people, even celebrity musicians, even if they step out by mistake, everybody is snapping them, they have to run. Now, they may be going to hell. Are we together? But as far as value is concerned, generally speaking, they are communicating value. It's just the content of their music that is demonic. Their vocal training is excellent to a fault. Now you come on stage and you say, I want to rise. What are you called into? I'm called into the music ministry. Really? Yes. What have you done so far? I've been, you know, a gentleman came and met me one time and he came and said that he's looking for sponsors. I said, what for? That he wants to produce an album. I said, who is mentoring you? He said, nobody. I said, can you play any instrument? He said, no. I said, who has ever approved, genuinely approved of your music? He said, no. I said, I'm not going to help you. I'm really helping you by not helping you, because I'm helping you realize the mistake fast.
Hallelujah. You have won the victory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You have won it all for me.
Listen, can't you see that this is God's bailout system? I came from a background where we were living in a hut with mud. The mud is not in your mind. The mud is not in your mind. Jesus was born in Nazareth. They said, can anything good come out of Nazareth? He broke that limit. Stop giving excuses. Make up your mind from today. There is something my world can celebrate. Years ago, when I was staying in a little room, praying and reading books, all my money went to buying books. Buy the truth and sell it not. God, you have given me grace for music and worship. Who can invite me because of the grace I carry. Don't flatter yourself in mediocrity. Challenge yourself based on a reference that is global. Don't flatter yourself. You make mistakes, you sing off key, and someone says, Kai, you know, Elijah, this is fantastic. You say, really? No, you didn't do well. You didn't do well. We were glorified because of the anointing, but vocally speaking, you didn't do well. This lack of preparedness is what makes people to mock themselves. Any competition they hear around, they will come. Have you seen people like that? And they say, why are you here? Say, I'm here to win. And you watch your competitors. Just by looking at them, you see the flawlessness of their preparation. And just the preliminary screening, you are back home. And then you say, no, in Nigeria, this is because this person is Yoruba. That's why they didn't take me. No, sir, you are not good. Be honest with yourself. I'm not saying you cannot be good. Listen, value is only valuable when competence is added to it. Value only becomes valuable when competence is added to it. Yesterday I was studying on diamonds. I just decided to study on diamonds. I didn't know that there were different kinds of diamonds, different kinds. And I was seeing the diamonds and the rigor in finding them. And I mean their structure, the precision of their structure is what makes them valuable. Are you competent? Are you competent? Seest thou a man diligent in his ministry, diligent in his business? It's only a matter of time. You may be soaking garri now, but diligence is like a plane. It will lift you beyond the limitations. It can be raining and you just take a flight, and within 1 minute you are already out of that rain. You are not even aware that it's raining again until you land. Koinonia, I'm challenging you. I will be a wicked preacher, I will be a wicked man of God to not challenge you in the area of value, because that's what I'm doing with my life. And by the grace of God and in all sincerity, that's what has brought me where I am. And I told you, where I am now is my preparation of yesterday. Tomorrow will reveal to you what I'm doing today. Value always precedes manifestation. So when you see a man manifest, that's not his true state. It is his passive state based on your seeing him now. In business, in ministry, there are many pastors who don't know how this thing works, and they may never find out. There are many people who don't know how this thing works. I'm sorry to say, but look at Zaria as a case study. Almost every business in Zaria, almost, not all, but almost every business in Zaria is tainted by mediocrity, smallness, average. There's nothing world class. There's no touch of excellence in it. We are limited because of our culture. I have my small shop. This is nice. We never learn. Someone has paid the price and made the mistake for you. Then you make it again. No, you must learn from other people's mistakes. Are we together? I have hardly seen things in this city, and I say it with all humility, that have impressed me to know that this is at a level of a global repute. From our hotels, are we together, to our restaurant services. In fact, from the most part, they are terrible. Yet there are many of us seated here. If I ask you now, what did you say? I've been cooking. You are the only one who has not eaten. The fact that I've not eaten your food means nobody has recommended it. And that means they've been flattering you by saying it's sweet. If food is delicious, we are not stupid people. Jimmy's wife makes cakes. Everybody knows. She's not necessarily done any great marketing. Let her works speak for her at the gates. What is so exceptional about what you do? What do you do that will make me feel like I am losing a lot if I don't partner with you? Everybody say competence. Say it, competence. Say it again, competence. Listen, if you pay attention to what I'm saying, you will reap an endless, you will reap an endless benefit. Competence. Favor then is when preparedness. The day God wants to bless you, he will station your destiny helpers close to you. Men and women who have the perception and the strength to reward your value. And then he says, now you have prepared yourself. There are too many, you know the problem with many of us, look at me, this pressure for recognition. I want to know that I'm a CEO. I said it, I think it was to the School of Ministry students. People write books after 10, 20 years of a track record. But in Nigeria, people write books to start up what they are doing. So someone who has nothing writes 81 keys to the billionaire lifestyle. A book is an authorization for men to listen to you based on a result that is obvious in your life. You are documenting your persuasion to create a track for people to follow. Years ago, a few, well, they are not really my friends, but they are ministers too. They met me and said, Apostle, at your level, there are some bishops who are not like you. You should be on TV and radio. I said, I hear. So that I will get to a point where I'm limited and I have to beg for partners. Isaiah 77, give me Isaiah 61, give me 61 naira or 610 naira. I don't want to do all those things. I don't want to stand on airplane gimmicks. I want a situation where the day Koinonia comes on air, someone will say, this is what I've been looking for. I have a business that is producing $10 million every month. I've been looking for a ministry to sponsor. This is it. Solutions provided. Problems solved. Lives transformed. And you enter your Sabbath at once. Please hear me, Koinonia, and all those following. Not everybody is a victim of this recession. I tell you the sincere truth from the depth of my heart. I say it with all humility and not in any boastful way. I say it with all humility and not in any boastful way. The finance of this ministry has skyrocketed in a way and a dimension that is irrecoverable this year, more than any year put together. Now, please, I'm sorry if it looks like I'm boasting. I'm only challenging you. In the time we call recession, say something I do not know. Say it again. Something I do not know may be responsible for my limitation. One of my pastor friends started bus transport, bus services, and he called me. He said, Apostle, I can't believe this. You've been transporting people on bus services and we're not so much in our church. Just at one junction where everybody will wait. After 1 month, we looked at when they sent the report. I said, nobody, a trek from wherever you are coming. And we've done this without fail. Not for Friday's program. Anytime this ministry is holding any program, once it is night, we're a responsible ministry. At any time, whether it was planned or not. Brothers and sisters, there is something that is being done. This is where I'm taking you to. It was not like that. Our first crusade, they were almost locking me because of 150,000 Aaron. Whereas the money that is circulating now was still there. I have learned through pain. I have learned through mistakes. I've learned through mentorship, and you are receiving it for free. I pray that you will treasure it, and I pray that it will lift you higher than ever. Some of you are about to get married. You know you are not ready. Are we together? You already know, not by revelation, by wisdom, that your wife is going to suffer. You know that your children are going to suffer. How do I know that? There is no plan. Dotham became mighty because he prepared his way before the Lord. You are not preparing your way. There can't be greatness. Don't be too quick to show forth. Prepare. Everybody say prepare. Prophesy to yourself. Say myself. Prepare. Myself. Be competent. Myself. Work on yourself. Hallelujah. Prepare. Don't make noise. Don't take this colleague mentality moving around. I used to know you, Pastor Femi. We are fellow pastors. Colleague mentality is the key to the undoing of many people. Oh, we were classmates, the same class, the same university, the same this. We are both doctors, we are both professors. No, no, no. The Bible says one star differed from another in glory. Say in the name of Jesus, there is an ability. Say there is a gift within me that is greater than Zaria, greater than Nigeria. There is an intrinsic value within me that can bless me, that can bless the kingdom, and I will search it out. Hallelujah. There is an intrinsic value. Now, intrinsic value has to do with value that is inherent. The only thing you do is to develop it. Is there. I'll give you an example. Intellectual property is an intrinsic value. You don't refrigerate it. You don't warm it. You don't keep it in a safe, in a bank. It's there, it's there. You've trained your mind, intelligence, intellectual property is there. He's playing this keyboard now. This is intrinsic value. It's value within him. Value that does not depend on the external environment for its performance. Are we together now?
Yeah.
A photocopying machine is not an intrinsic value. The machine needs a demand. The machine needs a lot of things. The machine needs light. Are we together? The greatest way to rise is to work first on your intrinsic value. You have the grace to sing, work on it. You are an entrepreneur, work on it. Don't say I'm a CEO. CEO that is not producing results is a sign to sit down. Say I'm a potential CEO. There are people moving all around with complimentary cards and flattering themselves. I am this and that and that. I'm into real estate, agro, allied products, and so on and so forth. We have branches in Ghana, Benin Republic, Port Harcourt, Lagos, and so on and so forth. And you look at the person who is talking. You ask him, sir, what do you know about real estate? Say, look, that's not the most important thing. Me, I'm telling you, my father did it. He gave me, and he has one plot of land somewhere. You see, we mock ourselves. Packaging is only meaningful when there is content. Packaging is only meaningful when there is content. Packaging without content is like a balloon. You hold a balloon and claim that the balloon is a metal. You will just touch it and it will burst. I sing better than many people who are called into the music ministry. Yet, they want me to buy their album. No. I told you last week, there are many people who claim they can cook. They have restaurants. Are we together? And you start bullying people and say, shouldn't you come and eat in my restaurant? I saw you the other day. Ella, you should come to my restaurant to eat. Are we not fellow Koinonia people? She wants to be healthy. She wants to be healthy. And as far as it is concerned, you have not worked on yourself. One of our school of ministry ladies, she made one beautiful work, just a beautiful artwork. The students saw it. I mean, she's here. Very fantastic artwork. And when I saw it, I said, my goodness, this is excellent. I told her, improve yourself and monetize your value. Monetizing your value is the last thing you do when it is flawlessly competent. Then you place a price on it. Are we together? Now, I want everybody to write. Write three things you know God has put in you that must be developed and deployed. Please write it down. Young, old, write it down. Type it, write, do whatever it is. Please write it down. Don't flatter yourself. Don't write what you don't have. Just patiently think and you'll find your own. Don't just write because your neighbor wrote something. Value. Value. Aaron is here. He handles most of the logistics of the, you know, people around, different kinds of logistics. Why? Because he's worked on himself and he's still working on himself. The other day I went to his house and I saw a blackboard close to his just a little like dining or thereabout, and his little office that he has, and I saw him writing goals. I saw targets. I saw plans of action. I said, this is excellent. This person is going to go far. Please do not think discovery simply means it is worthy of reward. That you have discovered a thing does not mean they will reward you. It must be developed to the highest level of excellence and then communicated with integrity, communicated with discipline, and communicated with the anointing. Hallelujah. I met a pastor and the pastor told me something. He said, man of God, he's quite an elderly man. He said, if you continue going the way you are going, you're going to have such an exceptional ministry. I said, thank you, sir. I intend to. And that's why I seek people like you to add to my life. I am not ashamed of my ignorance. I'm not ashamed of my limitations and the thing that I do not know. There are many things I do not know. I know some, but there are many others. If I knew them, I would not be where I am. And I humble myself to seek for knowledge. I see the way people trivialize knowledge and trivialize the sacrifices of others. Are we together? You call somebody you perceive to be valuable, and then you tell the person, when can I come and meet you? Or when can you come and meet me? And the person says, why? You say, I have a business proposal. I want us to rub minds together. Sit down with your broke, bad attitude, and you will never rise. Never rise. There's so many people who do that. Why am I challenging you? I want you to rise beyond the recession. You've heard the testimonies of people. This money has not flown anywhere. This greatness has not flown anywhere. The concept of recession to an individual is a mirage. Hear me. Please hear me. I understand business. I'm not daft. I'm not stupid. I know what I'm saying. The concept of recession is not supposed to be explained from an individual platform. It is when you look at the economy territorially, societally, then you can say, based on the GDP of a nation, based on certain indices, a nation, when it does not meet certain things, then there is a recession, there is inflation, or whatever it is. But not an individual. There has been no time in the Bible where famine affected everybody. There has always been exemption. Those who offer value are the ones who are exempted. Please hear me. What gives you the justification that between today, Friday, and next Friday, something would have entered your hand? Or I'm not necessarily just saying money. Somebody would have acknowledged the fact that God is using you to bless him. My life has been transformed. What value do you have? You see, the anointing does two things. It activates something within you that was not there and amplifies something within you that is there. It activates something within you that was previously not there, or introduces, a better word, introduces something within you that was not there, like the healing grace, right? Like revelation, the capacity, utterance. But then it also amplifies something within you that is there, like creativity, like leadership, like your gift. So number one, your encounter with God that produces a fear of God in you. Number two, a transformed mind. Transform beyond your cultural limitations. Number three, the discovery and the development of your abilities, your value. Please do not forget this. greatness, wealth, any kind of achievement in the kingdom is based on a reward system. It's not just the issue of the will of God. The issue of the will of God, as far as our greatness is concerned, is not a mystery. It is clear in the word. I know the thoughts that I think towards you, said the Lord, Jeremiah 29 and the 11th chapter. Thoughts of good and or peace and not of evil, to bring you a future and an expected end. Deuteronomy 28 from verse 1. It shall come to pass, if thou shalt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord, to do and observe all that I command thee this day, right? That you shall be exalted above all the nations of the earth, and this blessing shall come upon you and overtake you. There is always a part you have to play. There is a part that I have to play. Huh? Joshua chapter 1 verse 8. This book of the law, he says, shall not depart from out of thy mouth. He says, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do all that is written therein. Then he says, then, only then, shall thou make thy way prosperous, and you shall have good success. Success that does not steal away the time of your family. Success that does not steal away your life. Are we together? Give me 5-10 minutes. Let me talk a little. Let me take point three a little more. Write this down, please. I know that I've taught a lot about finances, but let me just talk for 5-10 minutes on a few things about our financial life. Number one, let me tell you something. A job alone will limit you. I want to expand your horizon and work on your creativity a bit. A job alone will limit you. Brothers and sisters, no matter how much of a job you get, no matter how great of a job you get, a job does not have the capacity to fund your assignment. Your needs are plenty. Family needs. The average African family has siblings that are looking up to you for assistance. It's capital intensive to live in Nigeria, to send children to school. Almost all of us here, by the time you are a Christian and you are born again, you have commitments to your church, to your group, to your ministry. And part of it is financial commitment. Part of it, there are several things you have to do that take money from you. You are broke. Let me give us a little financial intelligence. We'll always add this. You are broke anytime your inflow is far, far less than your outflow. You will always, without fail, be on deficit. 1 naira comes into your life, you need 4 naira to go out of your life. You will be in trouble. You will have to be in trouble. You cannot be earning 50,000 naira, probably 100,000, and believe that in itself, you remove tithe, you remove a lot of things. It is just not enough. That's the challenge with our parents. 100,000 was enough when they had one child. Now they have 5 children, but their finances have not increased. So it's pinning them and straining them to death. Are we together? What then is the solution? Activate other streams of income. 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 Don't sit down running around and say there's no job. And I don't mean don't do small, mediocre things that waste your time, your energy, your money, and then at the end nothing comes out from it. Activate streams of income. Work on your mindset. Monetize your intrinsic value that is being developed. You will rise above recession, I tell you. Are we together? Did you know, for instance, every week we rent chairs in the dozens. During the miracle service, we rent thousands of chairs in the dozens. That's someone's business. Are we together? That's someone's business. Every week, there are things only in this ministry alone that can make an individual a millionaire. if he knows how to create a system around that value and supply it. Just koinonia alone. Please activate streams of income. Take responsibility for your life and don't give people anything substandard. You are insincere and you are ungodly when you whet the appetite of people over a value you know you cannot offer. Don't be that insincere. Make sure that you have worked on yourself and you are competent enough. Then you can open up your hands for value. Don't collect a contract to help somebody roof his house and then you roof nonsense. No, don't do that. If you know you cannot work on it, package yourself. Work on yourself. I work on myself every day. I returned back from my trip yesterday. As tired as I was, I made sure that my daily goals were met. Please, don't you think that it is just the anointing? The anointing is there. I'm going to talk about it. Paul said, I am what I am by the grace of God. He said, but this grace was not showered upon me in that I labored more than ye all. I prepare an average of 2 to 3 sermons every week. It takes time. It takes research. It takes staying in the spirit. There are other aspects of my life I am involved in. What are you doing? There is no laziness. Don't sit down and say, oh God, when will you change my situation? Don't sit down and say, who will come and marry me out of this problem? Nobody. At least nobody in Koinonia. And brothers, don't wait and say, which lady? Bible says, he that finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. Are we together? This is the undoing of Africa. This is the undoing of many people. My neighbors, they bought a few months ago, they bought a grinding engine. And the moment they bought that grinding engine and stationed there, at once they became relevant in that environment. Almost all the houses within that environment no longer enter a car and go to Samaru to go and grind beans or whatever. They come to them. What is their reward? The transportation of everybody who should go there now comes to them. A place that was previously very quiet and conservative, now you see the people. Early in the morning, the engine is up and they are grinding, sometimes till late in the night, and they are making money from it. Please, I want you to go back and sit down and be sincere with yourself, young and old. Sit down and say, I now see why things are not working in my life. I now see why I'm feeling the heat of the recession. I am not saying you should be a money monger. Remember, we've done financial dominion. So you cannot sit down and say, now, which business do I do? That's a wrong question. How do I develop myself to rise to a point of value? When you are valuable, then now you build a system around that value. That's what we call business. Business is simply the art of packaging your value that has been developed to serve a targeted people. Then you receive financial rewards, among other things. There's nothing mysterious about business. Building a business is simply having a value, converting it to a product or a service that is needed and useful, and then creating a system that informs your potential customers of what you have to give. Very simple. But it's not as simple as it sounds. The last point. Rise to a point of value. Rise to a point of value. The last point. What is the fourth key to becoming transgenerationally relevant? The fourth key to rising beyond recession. We name the series Thrive. To thrive does not mean to manage. To thrive means to blossom. Thrive gives a picture of a plant growing out. You see how a plant grows out of the soil, and you see it moving regardless of the strength of the soil. It shoots through it and it blossoms. That's what it means to thrive. You don't thrive if there are no obstacles. You thrive in spite of obstacles. The fourth key is an encounter with the anointing.
Anointing fall on me. Anointing fall on me. Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall on me. Anointing fall.
Sing it one more time, everybody.
Anointing fall on me. Anointing.
Let the power of the Holy Ghost.
Let the power of the Holy Ghost fall on me.
I love what I'm about to share with you. I'm telling you, because it's something that has changed my life. You see the amazing dimension of God when you understand the anointing.
You are amazing, dear. You are amazing. You are amazing. You are amazing. Oh, oh, oh.
Anointing, the anointing. Write this down. Let me give you a few definitions about the anointing. Kabrati sele karasunda brahatari adabalada.
You are amazing, yeah. You are amazing. You are amazing. You are amazing.
Write this down. The anointing is God's seal of authorization to represent Him in your territory. The anointing is God's seal of authorization. It's His authorization upon an individual to represent Him. The authorization for legislature, the authorization to represent God and to represent heaven on earth, the anointing. Number two, the anointing is the capacity to produce change and compel compliance. The capacity to produce change and compel compliance. Psalm 66 verse 3. How terrible art thou in thy ways. Through the greatness of thy power shall thy enemies submit themselves to you. To compel compliance. Number three. Now I love this definition. The anointing is an empowerment to manifest the possibilities in God. An empowerment to manifest, to reveal, to make known the possibilities that are resident in God. There are possibilities in God. It's a slogan that we use here. Experience possibilities. I think the media should do a montage on this. Experience possibilities. It's a slogan we have come to not just recite but believe. We've indoctrinated ourselves with the fact that there are limitless possibilities in God, and those limitless possibilities can find expression to the degree to which the unction, the grace of God is at work upon the life of an individual. The Bible is a compendium, an unfolding of the possibilities that are resident in God. revealed from generation to generation. Hallelujah. I got a testimony recently, and I'm sure they may be following online, and they sent it to me so I can share it in the open. When we went to Yola for the last crusade a month or two ago, we went to Yola. One of the person who was driving me around, he's a doctor, PhD, you know, with his wife. He's been married and they've been no child. This thing has not worked for them. And he decided that he was going to drive me around as a seed. You know, it's been a while they've been married. They're probably following now. And his wife couldn't take in. And, you know, when they were done, we're about to leave, I asked him, I said, what would you want the Lord to do? And then prayed for them. And he sent me a text. I think it was on our way to Bauchi now. It was on our way to Bauchi. I just got a text. He said, Apostle, the text is still on my phone. He said, I called to tell you that my wife went to the hospital and they said, I think she's 3 or a month pregnant. Say results. Shout it. Listen, results are evidences that God is alive. Not just an evidence that a man is anointed. It's much more than that. It's much more than that. It's much more than that. During our dinner, we'll be playing some videos. I hope that the media would consider that. I don't know what their plans are, but I hope that they should incorporate that. And one of the things that we're going to be doing is playing clips and showing you a few pictures of some of the external ministrations. And some of you will marvel and wonder at the hand of God and what he can do when a man is anointed. I've said it and I will say it again and again. The anointing does not make the difference. The anointing is the difference. How can the anointing make a difference when it is the difference? It is the very difference. When all is said and done, the grace that comes upon the life of a man. I have found David my servant, and with my holy oil I have anointed him, and the enemy shall not exert upon him. And then he reads on and he says, and in my glory shall his horn be exalted. Listen, let me tell you something. I have come to respect the anointing, not because of what it has done in my life alone, but this ministry, you see, is a place of possibilities. The testimonies, the tearful testimonies that have come, and it's not just because of Joshua Selman. Take the anointing out of my life and I'm as empty as this chair, you see. Are we together? Someone's life is going to be changed because of the anointing. Someone's life will rise because of the anointing. Listen, after you've worked on your gift needs to be anointed. It's one thing to be gifted, but it's your gift anointed. It says the spirit of man is the candle of the Lord, but candle without fire on it cannot give illumination. Are we together? There is an anointing that can come upon you and change the dimension of your entrepreneurial exploits, and you will see things happen that you never believed. There is an anointing that can come on you and your academic career just skyrockets in a way and a dimension. There is an anointing that can come upon your music ministry. So much more than the vocal competence and your work, you lift a voice and sing a song, and that song becomes somebody's healing. That song becomes someone's. I was watching a video today, Covenant Christian Center, and I was watching their leadership, their summit that they hold, their yearly summit. And I was listening to some speakers, and while they were talking, I said, my God, these guys are not just business moguls. They are absolutely anointed. Absolutely anointed. Are we together? Thou anointed my head with oil. You did not anoint my cup. You anointed my head. But that anointed translated to my cup overflowing. There is a relationship between what is on your head and what flows from your cup. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. In 2 Kings chapter 4, the wife of the son of the prophet went to Elisha. And Elisha said, what do I need to do to you? What is wrong? What is the problem? And she said, you know, this and that, there is this situation. And then he says, what do you have in your house? And she said, nothing. Thy handmaid had nothing except a little cruse of oil. And he said, that's it. He said, go and borrow vessels. Verse 3. Go and borrow vessels from all your neighbors. He said, borrow not a few. Borrow not a few. If you increase capacity, every oil assumes the shape of the container that holds it. If I pour this water on the cover, listen, if I pour this water on the cover will limit the water. This makes this water look as though it is triangular. Pour it in a plate, the plate will become like that. Thank you. Are we together? The anointing. And then when she got it, he now told her, he said, go and close the door. When the prophet was talking, the anointing is a living thing. It was hearing. It was hearing the discussion. And the moment she did that, she began to pour the oil. The oil began to multiply. Listen, it's not enough to be anointed. You must be anointed at a level that can command notable results. It's not enough to be anointed. The anointing is like currency. The anointing is like currency. 100 naira can buy sweet, but 100 naira cannot buy shoe. But it is still money. So don't say I'm anointed. The Bible says, Acts chapter 10, right? When Paul was speaking in the house of Cornelius, the salvation of the Jews, in verse 38, he said, how God anointed. Look at the extent to which God anointed Jesus. So it's not just that Jesus was anointed. Look at the extent. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. And then the Bible says, on the strength of that anointing, he went about doing good and healing all they that were oppressed of the devil. Why? For God was with him. The anointing is not an instrument to shake and fall down and roll. No. Those are just effects of the anointing on the human body. And then alongside with other spiritual dynamics that happen at the point of impartation. But the proof that a man is anointed is not shaking. Results. Results. I don't care whether you shake like a leaf. Results, brothers and sisters.
I just want to praise you. I lift my hands to say I love you. You are everything to me, and I exalt your holy name. I exalt your
said, go and ask Jesus, are you the Messiah? Is it true that the anointing is on you? And Jesus said, all right, watch this. The blind eyes open, the deaf ears hear. And he said, go back and tell John. How do you know a man who is anointed? Results. Results. Don't trivialize results. It's not all about the results. Are you joking? What then is it about? Results. Lives changed. Results. Hallelujah. When there are miracles and signs and wonders and lives transform, you speak to someone and just one prophetic word turns his life around. You've had all kinds of testimonies here. Someone with jammed result, 140 something. After prayer, you come back 260 something. How do you explain that? It's the anointing. A woman barren for 8 years returns with triplets, no CS. How do you explain that? Results. Are we together? a whole family almost ravaged with HIV, that cause, and it's not by sleeping around and just one prayer and everyone is healed, not just one person. It's called results. Brothers and sisters, let me tell you the truth. You may be criticized, but you will never be ignored. Once the anointing of the Spirit is upon the life of a man, upon the life of a business, Satan will raise criticisms. Why? So that your word will not be heard, so that you will not be believed, and so that people will not be blessed. But here's what the Bible says: you can do nothing against the truth. But for the truth, the truth was buried only for 3 days. After 3 days, it came back to life. Results. Results. Notable results. Not just results. It says the Spirit of the Lord. Please give us Isaiah 61. The messianic prophecy. It was a prophecy about Jesus Christ. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, he says, for he has anointed me to preach glad tidings to the poor, to bind up the brokenhearted, to set the captives free. Are we together? And then he continues and he says to proclaim liberty to the captives, and all of that, to proclaim the year of vengeance of our God, and all of that, to comfort all those who mourn, verse 3. And then he says to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes. That's what the anointing does. Beauty for ashes. The oil of joy for the garment of praise. Right? The oil of joy for mourning. The garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Then it says that they may be called oaks or trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he through them might be glorified. That they may be called oaks of righteousness. Brothers and sisters, when a man comes to a ministry, wretched, terrible, not born again, and something happens to him, it's called the anointing. You get born again, you get filled with the Holy Spirit, your life is transformed, your mindset is changed, you become a leader, you become an ambassador of the kingdom, then you are now anointed again to reproduce it. The anointing. There is nothing, one of our core values, as you know, in this ministry is the anointing. We believe in the anointing, and we believe that anything that is done outside of spiritual empowerment is a waste of time. Absolutely. So you will see the technical department preparing as though they are prayer band, because everything is done with respect to the anointing. They believe that the sounds are not just instruments of physics, they are spirit and life. Are we together? Listen, please hear me. I do not boast to have risen so far. Compared to where I need to go, I am just starting. But I can tell you this. I have had the privilege of mentorship to glean upon the shoulders of those who represent the systems of God upon the earth. And this is what they have done. And this is what they do daily. The keys are finite. The keys are not infinite, but every one of them is important for the door to open. The keys to your destiny, they are not infinite. They are not so many, but each and every one of them must be there in place. It's like a code. Your passion for God, a transformed mind, your gifts and your abilities, and then the anointing of God upon you. No, no, no. You can't be weak. You can't be weak. You can't be weak. It's my prayer that after this teaching, someone will not just hear and say, wow, this was nice. Honestly, when you see me talk like this, I talk from my heart, because this is it. You know, sometimes you can be looking for what you don't even know it is. But when someone who has found it says, look, this is what you are looking for, don't go around and waste your time and come back and say, I didn't know it was like this. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Fill this temple with your presence. Make sure you talk to him when praying. Holy Spirit,
You are welcome. Fill this temple with your presence.
Sing it one more time. Holy Spirit, you are welcome.
Hey, Holy Spirit, you are welcome.
Welcome to our lives and destinies.
Fill this temple with your presence. We wait on you, Lord, we wait on you. We wait on you, Lord, we wait on you. I wait on you,
I wait on you,
Lord, I wait on you.
Please pray, please pray. Those outside, you can come in. Clear the way for them so they can come.
Lord, I wait on you,
I wait on you. You are welcome.
I want you to sing the song. It's not a special number.
Fill this temple with your power.
That's what we need, the anointing upon our lives.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Fill this temple. We wait on you.
We wait on you.
We wait on you.
Lord, we wait on you.
I wait on you.
I wait on you.
Lord, I wait on you.
I wait on you. Lord, I wait on you.
Take my body, my soul, my spirit. On me, take my body, my soul, my spirit, breathe on me. Take my body, my soul, my spirit, breathe on me.
Shabarataya.
Take my body, my soul, my spirit, breathe on me.
This is my prayer, Lord.
You are the Holy Ghost, the Holy Ghost. You are the Holy Ghost, the Holy Ghost. Take your place, take your place.
Take
your place.
Take your place. Oh, 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 We are going to pray. We are going to pray. I want you to mean business with your destiny. I want you to mean business with your destiny. Don't worry about the rain. There are people who will direct you strategically. Don't be distracted. Munda ukaka sunanka. Ubangichi ai maya Ongi mama sunanka Ubangichi Nada ukaka sunanka Ubangichi ai saya Nagi mama sunanka Ubangichi Nada ukaka sunanka Ubangichi kai sayabo Nagi mama sunanka Ubangichi. Hallelujah. Prayer point number one. Father, I declare that my mindset must change. Lift your voice and pray. Pray from the depth of your heart. Shabarataka sotiketele ba 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 ba. Are you praying? Change my mindset. Change my mindset. Change my paradigm. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen. Hallelujah. Please help me technical. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to listen to me. The quality of your life on earth is dependent on your level of mental transformation. Not every information is needed and useful for your destiny. The fact that you are getting information does not mean you are growing. The fact that you are learning new things does not mean you are rising. The information you are getting must be needed and useful. It must be needed and useful. I'd like you to pray and say, Lord, the grace to edit everything that is not useful for my life and destiny. Lift your voice and pray. Shababarakata praskata bekarato sosobra. Ela kata praskata pradeshabra balarama. Embrusa secato sopratis calabaria da balarama da balarama. The right knowledge, the right information, the right knowledge, the right information. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's raining, but we're still praying. Hallelujah. Apologize to some of those who are at the aisle outside. Sincerely apologize. Hallelujah. As much as possible, if they can find any place, even if it's just outside, let's see how we can help them. But regardless of what condition you are in now, let me tell you, it is profitable what you are doing, because it will pay you more than money in the name of Jesus. I'd like you to pray and say, Lord, what have you put in my life that should bless my world? Reveal it to me. Lift your voice and pray. Lord, my gift, Lord, the abilities that you have put within me, in the name of Jesus Christ, I declare by the power of the Holy Ghost. There is an ability within my spirit. There is an ability that can change my life. There is an ability that can change my environment. Hallelujah. 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 We're praying. The Bible says there is this treasure. The vessel containing it may be earthen, but the treasure is not earthen. It says there is this treasure in Joshua Selman. There is this treasure in Koinonia, that the excellency of power may be of God and not of man. I'd like you to say, every gift you have put in me, Lord, bring it out. Bring it out. Bring it out. Bring it out. Lift your voice and pray. Every hidden potential. Every hidden potential. Oh yes, I'm rising beyond recession. I'm rising beyond limitation. There is a gift in me. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Isaiah 60 verse 1 says, arise, shine, not because you are tired of sitting down. He said, they that sat in darkness, the city of Naphtah and Zebulun, he said, they have seen a great light. Arise, shine, for your light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. The Bible says, for darkness, confusion shall cover the earth and gross darkness the people. He said, but upon you his glory shall arise. Verse 3 says, Gentiles, hallelujah, Gentiles shall come. You will not look for them. Gentiles will come to your light. Gentiles will come. You will not publicize. There is an unction. There is a gift. There is an ability. Gentiles shall come to your light. Then their kings to the brightness of your rising. It says your gates shall be continually open. They will not be closed day or night to receive the forces of the Gentiles. Listen. I want you to lift your voice and cry and say, all those who have been ordained to honor my gift I call them into my life. Lift your voice and pray. Please be serious. Everyone in every territory, called, ordained, anointed. Everyone called to honor your gift, your business acumen, your intellectual capacity, your education, your skill. Everyone ordained of God, everyone ordained of God, everyone ordained of God to honor what you carry. Call them forth by the power of the prophetic, by the power of the prophetic. I call them into my life. I call them into my destiny. I call them into my life. I call them into my destiny. In the name of Jesus, I command them to appear. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, let me tell you what the Bible says. For everyone that asketh, receiveth, and to him that seeketh, he will find, and to him that knocks, the door will be open. When you knock on that door, it will open, I assure you. I like us to pray. I like you to cry for a fresh anointing that will lift you higher. You are not down, but where you are is the limitation of the unction in ministry, in business. There is an oil, there is an unction. Thou anointest my head with oil. Lift your voice and pray for more. Fresh grace. Fresh grace. Fresh grace. Upon my life, fresh grace. Upon Koinonia, new levels, new dimensions of kingdom exploit for the sake of His Majesty. Oh, upon my life, I cannot be ordinary. I cannot be ordinary. There is a supernatural anointing, the power of the Holy Ghost, taking me higher, taking me higher. The power of the Holy Ghost, a superior unction upon my life, a superior unction upon my business, a superior unction. Pray. Upon my marriage, a superior unction. An unction that cannot be ignored. 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 Everyone that asketh, receiveth. Everyone that asketh, receiveth. Everyone that asketh, receiveth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen. It's raining, but hear me. I am a living testimony that when a man cries unto God, he can hear. The last 2 or 3 months, have been phenomenal seasons of my life, stepping into strange operations of graces and unctions, testimonies beyond imagination. You can pray it through genuine desire, a heart that is thirsty. Thou son of David, have mercy on me. Thou son of David, anoint me.
Affect my life, breathe on me. I look to you for life. Affect my life, breathe on me. Affect my life, breathe on me. I look to you for life. Affect my life, breathe on me. Affect my life, breathe on me.
Of Solomon says, because of the ointment, so do the virgins love thee. Because of the ointment, so realms you have never entered will come to you. It's not just talking of women. Because of the ointment upon my head, so do the virgins love thee. They desire to be with you. We are going to pray. I want you to pray this prayer with all your heart. You are going to challenge every door of limitation. See, let me tell you, honestly, if we are to be truthful with ourselves, there are people, you are not down, but you are not up either. You can move up. When you are up, you know you are there. I like you to pray and say, I challenge limitations. You are a spirit and I speak to you. This season you are living, lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. I challenge limitation over my life. I challenge limitations. I challenge limitations. Everything fighting my anointing, fighting my influence, fighting the glory of the Lord upon Koinonia, I challenge you in the name of Jesus. We come with the rod of a higher priest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are going to pray again. It's a year of multiplied grace and influence. Multiplied grace. Influence means a platform. A platform that can afford you an opportunity to shape the minds of people. I like you to pray. We have been indoctrinated that influence is a bad thing. Without influence, the kingdom cannot advance. The key to kingdom advancement is not just evangelism, it's influence. The key, and if I be lifted up, not if I be talked about, I will draw all men. The capacity to stand at the front line of systems and legislate and be a communicator of the realities of Christ. I'd like you to pray and say, Lord, every influence destined for me, I decree that the grace for it must come on me. Lift your voice and pray. Oh, desire it. Your heart is pure. Influence. Access to kings. Access to nobles. Access to kings. Access to nobles. Access to kings. Access to nobles. Access to kings, access to nobles, access to kings, access to men of influence, access to custodians of systems. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One of the blessings and the secret that is responsible for the ease in this ministry is unusual access, unusual influence. God has given us access to politicians, access to governmental figures, access to kings, access to financial people, access to mentors, access to voices that can advocate, access to the credibility of men, access to their willingness to let you leverage upon their success. I want you to pray again and say, Lord, the access I need to end struggle, bring it to my life. Bring it to my life. Lift your voice. It's not as hard as we make it. Influence is powerful. Influence is powerful. Please, I'd like you to pray. Lord, I desire influence. The capacity to rise to a platform where your name can be heard, where your glory can be seen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Listen, the body of Jesus was hanging on the cross. The body would have remained there indefinitely. It was not a prayer warrior that demanded the body. A man of influence called Joseph of Arimathea. The Bible says he was a nobleman, a man of influence, and he used his access, are we together, to Herod, to Caesar, to demand the body of Jesus. He was a nobleman. He had influence. He had a virgin tomb. He had influence. And he said, look, Herod, I need the body of this man. And he said, you have it. There are things you have been praying for that influence will give you at a platter of gold. Are we together? I shared with you the testimony years ago. Listen to me. How that somebody was too short to get to NDA, and they said, you are disqualified. And then he came back, and because he had access to the emir, he complained, and the emir said they should go back to NDA and tell the people that emir yakara mishi say, the emir has added his height, they should take him. That's the power of influence. Are we together? I have gotten certain things in my life on the sheer platform of influence. You need it. Don't let mediocres deceive you that you don't need it. That's why somebody can come and bully a church with their land and collect it together with all the lawyers there. There is no influence. In the military, you should have influence. Somebody that can stand and become a representative. Imagine if Daniel was not in Babylon. Imagine if Esther was not in the king's palace. Imagine if Joseph was not in Egypt. Let me show you how men, there was a time they wanted to kill Paul. It was not prayer. Paul took advantage of his influence. Will you kill a Roman citizen? Because the issue was too serious. If he said, I'm an apostle, he would have died there. He said, I'm a Roman citizen. You don't touch Roman citizens. We have been preached far too long in the body of Christ that the desire for influence is carnality. No, carnality is the influence of things on your relationship to God. It has nothing to do with wealth. I want to be friends with multimillionaires. I want to be friends with governmental figures so that we can come and say, can you give us land for church here? And they say, you, please have it. Protocols have been bypassed in my life. Protocols have been bypassed in this ministry because God has granted us grace. We are friends with the Nigerian Union of Road Transport Workers. We are friends with the police, the military. You name it, from any angle, there is somebody to speak. When a student is victimized on campus, there are intellectuals among us. There are people who we can speak to. Oh, daddy, sir, mommy, sir, please, can you help this person? Let me tell you, it's a tragic thing when you are in the place of help and there is no voice to speak. Sometimes you are in the prison, you don't have access to the palace. You need somebody who is already in the palace to say, no, I endorse this person. This person is a man of integrity. It's not all about what you can do by yourself. Are we together? Nigeria that is full of bureaucracy and sentiment. You need men and women strategically positioned to help you. Matthew Ashimolowo was the first Christian to be allowed in Ghana TV, mainstream, to preach. They refused it. The indigenous pastors did everything to do. They refused it. But when he came, because he was connected to somebody who was connected to the government, and they knew that their daily bread was dependent on it, they allowed him. Who has God raised in your life to speak for you? Brothers and sisters, you cannot rise alone. Let me tell you, it's a mystery I'm sharing with you. You need men of influence. It's a class of destiny helpers. Are we together? That somebody can speak to you. Yes, I know the rent is due and they are about to throw you out, but somebody is a friend to your landlord. He can say, please, landlord, I know that you are supposed to drive this, but this person is my son. And they say, on grounds of relationship. Do you know, let me tell you, when how you know there is no helper in your life is when you get into trouble. You fight alone. You pray alone. When Daniel was in the den, Darius could not sleep. He rose up the next day. He said, oh, Daniel, has your God delivered you? When he said to you, he said, bring him out. Go and carry all those people. Throw them in. Who can punish your enemies? Who has what it takes to bring to book they that speak against the purposes of God? Every one of our board of trustees, by the grace of God, this ministry is a man or a woman of influence. Are we together? If there are people today, the government cannot come and bully them. There are churches. One of my pastor friends was speaking to me. He heads the branch of one ministry in a particular northern city. And he said how that they had refused. They showed him the letter signed by the governor that they cannot give land. It's impossible. No matter what you do, they cannot give church land. All the other churches that had it since. But in recent time, no, they will not give it. And a particular denomination in this country, they decided to do an expansion program, and they have 6 of their churches there. All of them own their land. They influence. Shout it again. Somebody called somebody who said, look, be careful. This seat you are in is for 4 years. You don't play with, no matter how stupid, no matter how a madman is, he does not enter fire by mistake. You need influence. There are many believers, there are many families that are bullied, and there's no one they can run to. There are many men of God that are bullied. They've not, the Bible said, be wise as serpents. You live in an economy, a system that is hostile to anything God. You need influence. Unfortunately, all the people in our lives are like us. We are the most influential persons among them. When God taught me this, I started making friends with billionaires. I'm not looking for their money. Access and influence. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray right now. My God, I'm seeing so many people. I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm just responding to the Spirit. Lord, you asked us to lift our left hands up. Whatever that means, there are people. I see fire right now. It's going to begin to come on people. Lord, the moment that comes on their family, let there be massive deliverances. At the count of 4, that will happen now. 1, 2, shaka patakata. 3, 4, bring them out. Bring them out. Bring them out right now, inside, outside. I'm seeing the Spirit of God. There's fire moving to families. please, let's save time. Shabatakarataya. At the word of the Lord, I place the word of the Lord upon that situation of witchcraft. Inside, outside, it's over, it's over, it's over, it's over. I come with a word of prophecy. I prophesy as I've been commanded. Miracles, deliverances for families. Enough is enough, oh God. Bring them. There are so many people outside. So many people outside. All the overflows. I see miracles. It's like fire. It's like fire. Hallelujah. Keep your hands down. I'm seeing fire, and it's going to come upon the heads of people. And the Lord is saying it is still the deliverance. Lord, where are they? Where are they? Where are they? Right now, all over the congregation, I prophesy like fire. I see like an eruption, a volcanic eruption coming on the heads of people. The heads of people. Sheketekata, where you are, the fire will meet you there. Where you are, where you are. The enemy has done this. We command every havoc. We command every havoc. Kaba tayata. I tell you, I see deliverance for many families. Say after me, in the name of Jesus. Say in the name of Jesus. I command every spirit causing the tragedies in my family, be exposed now. Lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. The light shines in the darkness. The light shines in the darkness. As you are praying, the power of God will come upon you. As you are praying, the power of God will come upon you. Be exposed. The spirits eating up finances, eating up joy, eating up peace. Kapatatata. Ekerato sotobashiata. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. I see written on this pulpit altars, and I want to pray. An altar is a platform erected by men that grants access to spiritual operations. Altars, 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 altars. At the count of seven, I tell you, many people, this is not just families now. One, two, three, four, get ready. Five, six, seven, right now. Right now, right now, right now. Altars, catch fire. Altars, catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Catch fire. Shake it, take a poro sotoba. Lift your hands, everybody. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. The Lord is asking me to call situations. The moment I call them, all those who are victims of it, the power of God will come upon them. Please, we are going to be fast. Right now, I pray. The spirit of failure upon people. I'm seeing it. Lord, wherever they are, right now, at the count of three, let there be an exposition. One, two, three. Go, go, go. Failure, failure, failure. Causing failure.
in lives, failure in destinies, failure in ministries, failure in business. Failure in academics. Every form of failure, fire is coming on it right now. Fire is coming on it right now. Inside, outside. No, you can't stand it. It's your deliverance. It's your word. It's your prophecy. It's your word. That's why you came. Failure. Lift your hands, everybody. I'm seeing chains, and the Lord is saying, let delay leave my people. That's what I'm hearing. Lord, where are those whose lives have been under one spot, inside and outside? At the count of three, I'd like you to shout Jesus. Delay is leaving now. One, two, three. Go, 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 go. Delay, delay, delay of all kinds, of all kinds. Arato soto pekete. Delay. Delay. All kinds of delay. All kinds of delay. All kinds of delay. Be broken now. Now. Let her go in the name of Jesus. Let her go. I break that chain now. 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 That chain of delay. That chain of delay is broken over your life in the name of Jesus Christ. God is breaking delay. Listen. Hallelujah. I've prayed this prayer in this place before, and the Lord is asking me to pray it again. That the destinies of men can be exchanged so that you are walking, but you are not living your destiny. It's like you are living another person's life. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Please take this prayer seriously. It will do wonders in your life. Lift your hands inside and outside. And you watch what will happen now. Lord, I pray. My God, I'm telling you, all I'm seeing in this place is fire. Any man here, any woman whose destiny has been exchanged so that the life you are living is not your blueprint, right now, let the exchange, let there be another exchange, another exchange, another exchange. The power of God is coming on people right now, right now, right now. Release your destiny. Release that mother's destiny now. Release that mother's destiny now. My goodness. Kapata shatatata. It's your destiny. It's your destiny. You can't leave another person's script. Every witchcraft, every manipulation, I curse it now. I curse it now. I curse it now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord is asking me to pray for people with strange movements in their body. I tell you, I feel fire. It's like people are literally bathing in fire. Strange movements. I want to pray. There are many ladies, many mothers under this category. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I stretch my hands. every stranger. There is a lady, you feel a physical snake moving on your body. But right now, in Jesus' name, at the count of three, fire from the throne. I command those spirits roaming around the bodies of God's people. 1, 2, 3, go. Go now. Leave their bodies. Strange objects. Hallelujah. Please, sisters, lift your hands. I want to pray a very powerful prayer for our sisters. The devil will prefer to get one woman to 10 men, because a woman is a gate in the realm of the spirit. I tell you, no power will stand. Something is about to jump out of somebody's life. Break every chain. Let her go right now. Your destiny must open up in the name of Jesus Christ. Break every chain. Lift your hands, sisters. There are many ladies here under several oppressions. That's why many things are not working. But sisters, as surely as the Lord lives, at the count of three, I'd like you to shout Jesus. You will be surprised to see what will happen to you. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Deliverance for you right now. Deliverance. Help them, my goodness. Please help them. Gates. Be broken. Papataya. Gates. Be broken. Gates. Be broken. I'm praying it again. Lift your hands. Every devil that came here with you must let you go. Lift your hands. There are sisters. There is already a programming on your destiny to fail. A programming to be barren. Who is this God that can look into time? Wherever they are, at the count of three, may the power of God fish them out. 1, 2, 3. Take that fire. I open your destiny. Every lady, every sister, you are a gate in the realm of the spirit. Mighty deliverance, mighty breakthrough. It's over by the power of the Holy Ghost. Over.
Break every chain.
Hallelujah. Now I want to pray for the brothers. Lift your hands. Listen, let me tell you. There is a spirit that makes men not to be productive. Hear me. It's a mighty deliverance that will happen to many men right now. Pay attention. There are men who are just growing old. There's nothing happening in their lives. It's not your fault. There are keys that have been withheld from you. But that thief must be exposed. Lift your hands. I want to pray. Ancestry. That's the first thing we're dealing with, the brothers. Brothers, lift your hands. I want to pray. Many of you will be surprised to see what happens. Every spirit of ancestry, every spirit of inheritance over any brother here, stopping his advancement, at the count of three, some of you will be very surprised. That fire will come on you. Are you ready now? One, two, three. Take it. Take it. Take it. That fire. Help them, please. Help them. My goodness. Kaparata kata. Brothers are coming under this unction. It's time to move forward. It's time to move forward. Help them. I curse that spirit. I curse that spirit. I curse that spirit. Hallelujah. God does this all the time. And I don't know why God is doing this again. If he did it before, he can do it again. Listen, I see something strange happening. Strange happening in the spirit. And I'm seeing the spirit of the Lord moving. And God is saying he's visiting Easterners. Easterners, Igbo people. That's what I'm seeing. There are altars that need to be broken. Please pay attention. I'm about to pray right now. Wherever they are, always he will do it. You are from the east, get set. Be sensitive. Come on, you shouldn't be doing that. Shaparato kaparatia. Easterners. Lord, wherever they are, it will come like fire on you. You will be surprised to see what will happen to you now. The Spirit of God goes to the east. The Spirit of God goes to the east and is bringing deliverance. Deliverance. Strange deliverance. Igbo people. Strange deliverance. By the power of the Holy Ghost, he's visiting your soil. Visiting your foundation. Visiting your soil. If he did it before, he could do it again. Same God back then, same God right now. If he did it before, Abia, 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 Abia said, Shakata Barata, Abia, Abia, the Spirit of God is moving across Abia. Miracles, breaking foundations. If he did it before, he can do it again. Same God back then. Hallelujah. Many of you wonder why God does these things. There are signs and wonders. He steps into, you will see the testimonies that will come from this thing. Strange visitations. Lift your hands, everybody. Joshua Selman. God, please. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. I'm walking in the spirit and I see a map. And the Lord is asking me to jump upon it. And I see Kaduna, Southern Kaduna. That's what I see. Right now, Lord, at your word, move. Southern Kaduna, visiting men and women. That's what the Spirit of God is saying. I speak it. I place the word of God upon it. Lord, go to that region right now. Southern Kaduna. Southern Kaduna, from Saminaka to Zonkua. Everywhere. Move. Let the power of God touch people. Liberty for territories. Liberty for territories. No matter where you are, I'm telling you, Southern Kaduna, fire is falling. Fire is falling upon your soil. Upon your soil. Southern Kaduna. Southern Kaduna, that's what I see. Southern Kaduna. Connected to Southern Kaduna, there is a miracle happening. Altars in Southern Kaduna, I come against you by this apostolic and prophetic mantle. Leave God's people now.
Yeah, na na na. Yeah, na na na. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, na na na. Yeah, na na na. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, na na na. Yeah, na 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 na.
Hallelujah. Listen, let me tell you, this operation of the Spirit, I found it working in my life, is powerful. God just calls a territory, and everyone is like a digital spiritual system. It's not something you just do by guesswork. It's the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God. The Spirit of God. God is still touching Kaduna people. I'm still hearing it in my spirit. God is still touching Kaduna people. There's no escape. Any family tied to any altar comes under fire. Any Kaduna family married to Kaduna, living in Kaduna state, hallelujah. Please lift your hands. We're still praying. I want to pray for students now. Something miraculous will happen here now. I want to pray for students because I see conspiracy to short circuit people's performances. I'm going to pray. But there is a God in heaven with an all-seeing eye, and there is an unction he can release. I'm going to pray. Listen, let me tell you, you will be surprised to hear the testimonies that will come. The way God is working this night is very supernatural. If the power of God comes upon you, I want you to know that an angel is doing something over your result. Just hear what I'm saying. Hear what I'm saying. I'm speaking by the Spirit. Father, there are people whose results need to be worked upon divinely. And where are they? I see almost 45 people. Right now, at the count of three. One. Results. Two. Three. Let the angels begin to move. As they move, it will affect you. As the power of God touches you, your result is being worked upon by the power of the Holy Ghost, inside and outside. Results, results. Carryovers, receiving the mercy of God. Receiving the mercy of God. God upgrading CGPAs. Upgrading CGPAs. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. CGPAs, by the power of the Holy Ghost, supernaturally, by the creative power of prophecy, receive it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. that has refused to let you smile, hear me, that joy and laughter will not come out of your mouth. I stand tonight in the name of Jesus. I bring that thing under fire. I bring it under fire. I bring it under fire. Shake ta ta ta. I bring it under fire. Hallelujah. Lift your hands. Just lift your hands and be silent if you can. A miracle is happening. A miracle is happening. This is what I'm seeing. I'm seeing letters in the spirit. And these are employment letters. Hold on. Just keep your hand. Just do what I'm asking you to do. You will be surprised. Many of you, for you and for your loved ones, the Lord is just asking. Just lift your hands. Father, at least 17 people inside, outside, there are up to 5 people online. Supernatural jobs. May the angels of breakthrough take this word to the people right now. Right now, right now, right now. Receive it. Receive those letters in the spirit. Receive it in the spirit. Receive it in the spirit. Receive it in the spirit. For you, for your loved ones. I don't care what they read. I don't care what they have. We give them jobs by the power of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. I see at least 4 people. 3 of them are ladies in the congregation. Your mothers are due for promotion, but they've done everything they know to do. As I'm speaking right now, an anointing will come upon you to signify what he's doing to them. Lord, go ahead. Locate them. Promotion. I force it. I force it now. I force that promotion. Take it. Carry it for your mothers. Whoever is sitting on their promotion. Whoever is sitting on their promotion. The judgment of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to pray for the sick, but there are 2 women I want to pray for here. You are trusting God for the fruit of the womb. Now, I know there are many people. Listen, there are 2 women particularly. One of them, the anointing of, please, no standing for wife, no standing for anybody. If you are not the person, sit down. If you are not married, don't come here. Praise God. Please, the 2 women by themselves, I'm going to pray. That lady, oh, let me pray for her. That devil, let her go. Don't disturb us, don't waste our time. Out, out now. Out in the name of Jesus. I curse you by the God of heaven. In the name of Jesus. You are living, release her family, release her destiny right now. You're a noisemaker. Out you go and don't waste our time in Jesus' name. I set her free in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, please listen, we're going to pray for those 2 women. I don't know if there are here, 2 of them here. There's 1 of them. I'm seeing 1 of them. The anointing of the spirit is going to come upon her. I don't know who that person is, but there's 1. Please, we have such people. We have to be fast. If I mention your case, once we give you 1 minute, there's no response. We have to move so that God can help us. Please, except if they are outside there, then that's all right. A married woman that need the fruit of the womb, we have to pray for them right now. Praise the Lord. How many of us are trusting God for healing miracles in our bodies? Let me see your hands. I know many of our mothers are in this category. No matter what the case is, who is he? Stand up. Come, mother. The power of God will come upon that person. Please make sure they are married though. Please stand up. Stand up, madam. It's okay. Madam, it's okay. Please. Madam, look at me. Look at me. Look at me. How many years have you been married?
20 years. 20 years.
No child. Look at me.
20 years. 20 years.
Madam, look at me. Look at me. It's okay. 20 years of marriage. If that woman gave birth to a child by now, that's the other person, right? Barrenness. Why am I seeing her? I'm seeing chains around her stomach. You must remove it now. Remove it now. You are a devil of darkness. You hear my voice. Take off that chains now. In the name of Jesus Christ. There's no such thing as barrenness. It's nonsense. When a spirit sits on your stomach, there's no way a child will come. If you like, do whatever. You go to India and come back. You only waste money. But there is a God. Madam, please look at me. I want to pray for you. Are you here with your husband?
I came here for program. I'm a student here.
And you decided to. Where is your husband?
He's in Kafancha. We reside in Kafancha.
Okay, look at me, madam.
I'm a student here.
Do you believe God can give you a child?
I believe that's why I came.
It's okay, madam. Look at me. Look at me, madam. Place your hand on your stomach. I want to pray. How many of us believe this woman will come and stand and testify? If you are doubting this, you've not been in Koinonia. Madam, look at me. I want you to shout as loud as you can, I receive. Just shout it.
I receive.
This God, man, let me tell you, that is not working in your life does not mean it's not available. I've told you this thing. You have to believe there are dimensions in God. This woman you see will come and stand here with her child. Why is she here, madam? Why are you here? You are married for how many years? Give her the mic. How many years?
10 years.
The anointing is on you. Lay your hands on your stomach. Look at me, madam. Shout, I receive, if you believe.
I receive!
There's something leaving your body now. Let it go. You are a devil. Let her go right now. Something is coming out of your stomach. That's what I'm seeing. That's what has stopped your barrenness. Go and have your child. In the name of Jesus. Go and have your child. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please let me pray. Madam, make sure you people return with your testimonies. One, two, three. Is your husband here? Husband, please come, sir. I want to pray for you. Marriage is between two people, not three people. I look in the spirit and I'm seeing three people. Somebody is a stranger in this equation. Please come, sir. I'm seeing a third person in the spirit refusing to let this marriage work. I'm seeing a third person in the realm of the spirit refusing to let this marriage work. The devil is a liar. We are going to pray. Please hold your hands together. Just in one of your hands. Yes, I want to pray. Please put your hand on this woman. Watch what happens to you. There is a name, oh. There is a name. There is a name. Leave them. Leave them. Leave them. Leave them. Leave them. There is a name. Let her go. Strangers, kabataya, what God has joined together, I'm prophesying. That's why I said, hold your hands. Anybody whose hand is not held physically should not be in this equation. Therefore, I prophesy, any stranger Release what you have put in her stomach now. I'm seeing a snake. That's what I see in the spirit. I'm looking and I'm seeing a serpent. In the name of Jesus, release her now. Release her now. Kaparatakaya. Marriage was done legally. Therefore, you are an illegal occupant. Release her now. Let there be miracle children. Miracle children. I'm seeing a lady in the crowd. You are standing in for your sister who has been married for 5 years. Who is that? I want to pray for that person. 5 years. Your sister has been married 5 years. No child. No child. You are the one? Where is she? What's her name?
Deborah.
Where is she?
She's in Kenya.
How many years?
5 years.
No child.
No child. My brother, 6 years.
And you, the devil, wants to give you 4 years. Oh, cancel it. Destiny changer. You are the destiny changer. Will you come and change my destiny? My destiny today.
Come and change my destiny.
Hallelujah.
Destiny today.
Destiny changer.
You are a destiny changer. Come and change my destiny. My destiny today.
Please, don't just come out at will. What's, hold on, hold on. Coordinate yourself. Who is this? Hold on, hold on. Leave them, leave them. It's okay. Victor, leave her. It's okay. Calm down. How many years?
9 years.
Huh?
9 years.
Where is she?
She's in Azarembochi.
Kigiamata. That's the Sam Yembu.
Amen.
Why are you here, my dear?
She has been coming miscarriages.
For how many years?
Yes.
3 years. Her husband wants a boy, she wants a girl. Who will win? Did you hear what I said? I said her husband wants a boy, she wants a girl. Who will win? The man is the head of the family. See, this thing is being done by an anointing. It's not joke. It's an anointing. Look at me. Listen, every lady, place your hand on your womb. I want to pray for you. Just place your hand and leave it there. Hold on. Not for the brothers. Brothers, you don't have a womb. Just calm down. I know I'm praying for the sisters. That's why I'm praying. Because you see, listen, just follow what I'm doing. You will be surprised to see what will happen. The Bible does not allow you to test whether you are pregnant first before you marry. Is that true? So there is no way you know. You just marry and then find out. It's a disaster for a man, a family to pay the price, pay dowry and get married, and then there's that nonsense. So lay your hands. I want to pray for you. Let's attack it in advance. If you care for the prayer, lay your hands. For some of you, God is saving you years of misery. I'm seeing a number 21. And this is at least 21 people and families involved. Father, visit them now. Visit them now. Visit them now. I'm praying a miracle is happening to your womb. Visit them now. Visit them now. Visit them now. Right now, everything that wants to plant barrenness in your stomach, for every lady here and those watching online, I command it to leave you right now in the name of Jesus. I command it to leave you right now in the name of Jesus. My dear, look at me. Hold that baby. You, Ejimi, please give her that child. Just hold her so she doesn't fall. Just hold that baby. You are holding this child as a prophetic symbolism for your sister, for you when you get married, and for every other person. and for two other people who are in the congregation. This prophecy is connecting them. Where are they, oh God? Where are they, oh God? The anointing of the Spirit will locate them now. Right now, two of them in the congregation for this miracle. For this miracle. For this miracle.
Daddy, sir, please let me talk to you. Just give a few minutes. You and the madam close to you. Mommy, please come.
You are an usher, but you are praying. Come, let God answer your prayers. This lady is talking to the Lord. What was the issue?
It's my sister.
You are asking the Lord to do what?
Later, she has put to bed few times, but none of them is alive.
Because I'm seeing a spirit. As soon as she's giving birth, this is like an antelope. It eats the children. As in, is the child, sometimes most of the children will grow 9 months, you give birth, then they will last for only a few minutes and they will die. Hold my hands. Where is she?
Don't cry.
Where is she? What's her name?
Ladi.
Ladi, we speak to you. Lay your hand on your stomach. Lord, in the name of Jesus, we declare that this frustration is over. In the name of Jesus Christ. That is, I want to pray for you. Mama, good evening, ma. Please stand up. Who is the stubborn child that you want God to touch? Lift his picture up.
Victor.
This is your number one prayer. The one you want to marry. Where is the person? The one you want a job for that graduated. Job. The one that graduated. The graduate.
Yes, sir. Henry.
Mama, this is to tell you that God knows your situation. I hear what I'm saying.
Yes, sir.
This boy needs to be prayed for. So that they will not go and lock him in police station. Yeah, this I don't know who the boy is, but
very stubborn, sir.
That's what I'm saying, madam. It's okay, you are here for God to visit you.
Amen.
Who is Nonso? Nonso, I'm hearing the name Nonso. We are going to pray, Nonso, mama. We are going to pray in the name of Jesus Christ.
Very soon. Solomon, he want to marry. He's planning for his wedding, sir.
Okay, it's all right. We'll pray for him. In the name of Jesus Christ, Mama, I pray for you. You came here expecting the power of God to touch
exactly.
You. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Mama, do you want the pain in your body to stop?
Yes, sir.
You wake up in the morning and there's severe pain in your back. Sir, you know about this thing.
I know, sir. True.
And the Lord is going to do a great miracle for Mama.
Amen.
Because Mama, I'm seeing you. You can't wash for long.
Yes, sir.
You bend down to wash and your back is paining.
Thank you, Father.
In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord who has seen you is going to do a miracle for you. I command by the power of the Holy Spirit. Help Mama in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord.
Please, who is this? Huh? Nonso, my friend, are you Nonso? Help the boy, his trouser is removing. Who is that? Who brought him out? Maybe we should help him now. Sir, I want to pray for you. What do you do, sir?
I'm the proprietor of a school. I'm the pastor. I'm a civil engineer by training.
You own a school?
I do, sir.
Primary school?
Nursery and primary.
Nursery and primary?
Yes, sir.
You've been afraid to start the secondary school?
Seriously, sir.
Is that true?
I've been afraid.
Because what is happening in the primary, up and down, people are taking their children out of your school.
And they are owing money.
And you are trusting God for a miracle. Because you too, you need a lot of money now. As you are standing here like this, you need money.
Very correct, sir.
And this money is much. Don't collect loan. Don't collect loan. Loan is a way to die.
Dying in destiny.
Don't collect loan. Sir, I want to pray for you. One of the things you are going to start seeing as you minister the word is breakthrough. You will start seeing strange breakthroughs.
Amen.
In the lives of people.
Amen.
And then want to pray for your school, sir. Things are going down. What you need is not money. What you need is very qualified teachers who are really willing to teach. Because the people there, they will come today, few months, they want to leave. And when they, you know, they want, I will have to pray for you. The devil is a liar. Please lift your hands, sir. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the anointing for speed come upon you, sir. Supernatural speed. In the name of Jesus Christ. Grace and speed for you. Mama, God bless you. Please, who is this? Please, if we have not called your case, just be patient. We are going to pray for the sick now. Why is Mama here? Mommy, please come. Huh? Your son's name is Nonso. What's your name? Nonso. From where?
Manambo State.
You are a student here?
Dark.
Dark. Who is Chidi? I'm hearing a name, Chidi. 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 Let me pray for the person now. Mama, I'm going to pray for you. What you need, this one is not, I'm not even getting any word for your son now. So what God is saying, I should prophesy to you, is that he's bringing restoration to your life. God is saying, I should tell you, you see that song that I sang at the beginning of the meeting? I'm speaking Hausa, it's finished. That's what God is saying, I should tell you, that he's going to bring restoration to your life, supernatural restoration right now, by the power of the Holy Spirit. Hold my hands. I'm not getting any prophetic word for you, but in the name of Jesus, may God step in and do a miracle for you. Come and get something. You need to pray. Huh? You need academic breakthrough. Receive that grace in Jesus' name. Please, why are these people here? Huh? John, you are serving in yourself. Have you started serving?
Yes.
In the place where? Father, give him favor. As you go, let there be favor in Jesus' name. Amen. You are what?
John.
John. From where? Zaria. I said, Zamfara, John. But since you have come out, let me pray for you. Huh? Lay your hands on your chest. You love God?
God.
John. John, look at me. Please, God can give you a new beginning. You hear what I'm saying? Please, when I make altar call, John, run and join them. Huh? I'm going to pray for you, but that statement you made is not true. Oh God, help John. In the name of Jesus Christ. Because, you see, you have to be serious with God. Oh God, help John. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. She's older than she actually is. Huh? And there is a medical condition. This is a feminine thing that I'm seeing that is responsible for this. Can I change your house, sir? Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Turenshima, you understand English? I'm seeing happy birthday on top of you, and I'm seeing 50 years. How old are you? Shakarankina.
I born me on
1966. This woman is 50, but she's looking like 70. The devil is a liar. Huh? I'm seeing something. It's not something I can say in the open, but you need to be healed. Madam, this thing started happening to you since when you were about 17 years. Abone afara miki.
Yes. Sir.
About 17 years, this thing started. This is a serious woman issue. This is women talk. Father, we cancel this nonsense in the name of Jesus Christ. it must leave in Jesus' name. Beginning from today, experience the goodness of God in Jesus' name. May the Lord favor you too in Jesus' name. We want to pray for the sick now. Please, this is our miracle service. Bear with us. We have to deal with these things. You see that there are so many situations. We're praying. Everyone, you can be seated if you can or stand. We're soon going to be done, but I want us to pray. Are we together? Say after me, inside and outside, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Please say it like you're serious. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I declare that every closed gate standing before my destiny under this corporate anointing, swing open now. Lift your voice and begin to pray. Please, we are not just whiling away time. Pray, participate in the prayer. Some of us, that's what is affecting our lives. Every gate, Shabakaparoto Supra. Every gate. Over my finances, over every area of my life, be open now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Prayer point number two. I will still prophesy it upon your life. Say, in the name of Jesus, I call forth by the power of prayer every helper who will give me access to resources, to opportunities, and to new levels. I call them into my destiny. Lift your voice and pray. This is a powerful prayer. It's a very powerful prayer. Hallelujah. 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 I'd like you to prophesy and say, in the name of Jesus. Shout it, in the name of Jesus. As I enter these ember months, I declare that the mystery of divine preservation is upon my life. No death, no accident, no bad news. Lift your voice and cancel bad news. Make sure you are praying. Some of you are just looking. Pray. It's a very serious prayer point. No bad news. Shababakatarata kosotopai. I speak upon my life the mystery of divine exemption.
Scriptures talk about a blessedness that happens to a man whose delight is in the law of God. So as someone says, it says, but his delight is in the law of God, and that he meditates day and night. It says that man is like a tree planted by the rivers of water, whose leaves do not wither, and me bears fruit in every season. As you are about listening to this message, we believe that your life is going to be like that man planted by the rivers of water. Your leaves are forever growing today. And we know that your season will not pass
Pray.
By. You will forever shine and you will forever bear fruit. We have a lot of content to share with you. So we would entreat you to subscribe to this channel. As well as like us, hit that notification bell to receive more updates from us. Because we know that whatever content here is going to set you on calls at every time. It's going to make you attain whatever stature that Christ wants you to attain. Thank you.
Inside, outside, don't be tired. You're working out your salvation with fear and trembling. Before we pray on the request, I'd like you to pray and say, in the name of Jesus. Abba, now let's be serious. In the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus.
September,
October,
November,
December.
Hear my voice. I speak to you. Deliver to my life. Only blessings. No pain. No sorrow. No regrets. Go ahead and prophesy. Release power to your future. Release power to September. You shut your mouth. You shut your destiny. Release power to September. Release power to October. Release power to November. December. No plane crash. No bus crash. No armed robbery. No terrorism. Hallelujah. Say, in the name of Jesus, I declare a covering over me and my family members, wherever they are. The seal of the blood exempts them from tragedy. Listen, I shared some months ago a vision that the Lord showed me. I'm not one person who will stand and say, I saw this. Sometimes I see these things, I just pray. But it was upon my spirit and I said it. Remember, I spoke about the month of September. Everything you see us do here is prophetic. As you speak, it looks like you are joking, but you are releasing power to your future. He said, declares thou that ye might be justified. Hast thou commanded thy morning? You don't sit down and it delivers everything to you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Say in the name of Jesus, the seal of the blood is upon my life and my family members. Therefore, every spirit of death and loss and disaster must pass over my life and my family. Lift your voice and pray. No, not upon my life, not upon my loved ones. They are sealed by the mystery of the blood. No accident. No accident. No death. No obituary. No plane crash. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Stretch your hands towards this prayer request and begin to turn your request to testimonies. Go ahead. All those online, follow us. We are praying. You submitted your request and we are praying. Every request. Oh God, you have produced testimonies. Shaba katata. To the God that answers prayers. To the God that answers prayers. To the God that answers prayers. Let there be miracles, testimonies, breakthroughs. Turn around impossible situations, oh God. Let the barren come back to children. Let the poor return rich. Let the captive be set free. Let sinners come to the saving knowledge of Jesus. Let your breath be delivered. Let the sick be healed. Let jobless people return to jobs. Building projects completed. Spiritual lives be fired. Pray, pray. Hallelujah. I'm going to prophesy upon this request and I want us to agree with a resounding amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we declare, I use this as a point of contact. Lord, there are so many requests here representing the challenges in people's lives. Some for jobs, some for marriages, some for children, some for breakthroughs, some for study scholarships, others for help, others for reconciliation, others for souls, others for financial prosperity and breakthrough, others for restoration, some for deliverance, others for healing. Lord, I pray in the name that is above all names, we have a covenant of answered prayers with you. Therefore, Lord, arise as a mighty man and turn every prayer request to a testimony in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for all those who have sent their requests on Facebook, on Twitter, on any other platform. Lord, in the name of Jesus, give them strange visitations. Strange visitations from tonight. Strange visitations. And Lord, for every request that made it to this altar, I bow my knees to the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I pray, answer everyone in the name of Jesus. Turn every request to a testimony in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our time is gone. I really apologize. Let me prophesy over our lives. Do you know why prophecy is very powerful? Most of the testimonies that you hear, listen. Most of the testimonies that you hear are as a result of these prophetic words. Are we together? There are needs that God may not reveal and time may not permit to be able to extensively deal with. However, prophecy is powerful. It says in Numbers chapter 6 how that the priest will bless them and speak upon their life. There is something about a prophetic word coming upon your life. Those who know this, that is their edge in the spirit, have received it and it has produced dramatic results in their lives. Those who are careless about it, like they are about many other things, never really get to receive anything. Let me tell you, even if it's an impartation, even if it's a dimension of breakthrough, for as long as you stepped your feet here, and for all the thousands following us online, connect. Connect. Distance is no barrier in the spirit. It says, you have turned my mourning into dancing, and you have turned my sorrow into joy. I prophesy to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, joy like you have never experienced from January till now. Experience it in the name of Jesus. Joy like you have never experienced. Experience it in the name of Jesus. Hear me. I speak to your hands. Whoever is not doing anything here, because God said, be fruitful. I don't care whether it's a job, a business. I don't care whether you're a student, a graduate, a retiree. Whoever is having an idle hand between now and September miracle service, I put something in your hand. I put something in your hand. I put something in your hand in the name of Jesus. Not something that will mock you, something that will bring results. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. I put pressure on your destiny helpers. I put pressure on them. May they respond to you. I put pressure on their spirits. May they arise and help you. May they arise and help you. Hallelujah. Any situation in your life that is a recurrent decimal, it comes as though the breakthrough is coming, then the situation repeats itself. I prophesy, no more. No more. No more. No more. In the name of Jesus, no more. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Listen. Someone is speaking here like Mary and saying, how shall these things be? Lord, is it true that you will turn my life? I stand in the name of Jesus and I pray. A turnaround that will surprise you. Receive it in the name of Jesus. A dramatic turnaround. A dramatic turnaround. Hallelujah. 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 In the last 1 month of my life, God has brought breakthroughs and things to my life that I have always believed God. But there is something God can do in your life that will make you fear Him, not just believe Him. I prophesy to someone here. In the name that is above all names, that flight in the spirit that God can take a man and bring acceleration and not just surprise you, but even make you fear. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. I pray for everyone in business here and is nosediving. Things are not happening. You turn everywhere. You've done everything you know to do. You need the prophetic. I add that prophetic dimension to your business. I add that prophetic dimension to your business. Every dream that is still on paper, no finances, no grace to bring it out of paper. You have been writing things for donkey years, but the grace to put it at work. I declare between now and next month's miracle service, bring evidence, bring evidence, bring evidence, bring results, bring results in the name of Jesus. anyone called jobless in this place, that you have done everything to do, including giving money to people, and they have not brought jobs to you. I don't know how God will do it, but this mountain mover that can shake every mountain, I pray, may he give you not just a job, a miracle job. Miracle job. Hallelujah. Every family here that is stuck in one place, you try to rise, something brings you down. You try to rise, something brings you down. Now I prophesy to you, the grace for rising, receive it in the name of Jesus. The grace for rising, receive it in the name of Jesus. The grace for rising, receive it in the name of Jesus. Every embargo of bad luck upon your life, it worked for others until it gets to your point and people change their mind. I declare in the name of Jesus, in a way you have never seen favor and help, may you experience that throughout the month of September. Hallelujah. A dimension of anointing, a dimension of wisdom that you have never seen, receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive wisdom in the name of Jesus. Receive wisdom in the name of Jesus. And I pray for you, everything that needs to be broken in your life, habits and encumbrances that tie you down, I command that today is their burial. Today is their burial. Today is their burial. Hallelujah. I want to prophesy for someone who has never stood here to testify. In the name of Jesus, whatever has stopped you from climbing this altar to testify, I curse that spirit right now. 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 Hallelujah. Stretch your hands towards me. I want to speak to you. Everything that makes money run away from your hands. Money has a spirit. You have obeyed kingdom laws, but this thing is not just coming. You would try and labor and labor and nothing will come. These hands that are stretched towards me, as I stretch my hands back to you, by the mystery of divine supply, may you hold something you have never held in your life before. May you hold something you have never held in your life before. May you hold an amount you have never held in your life before. Hallelujah. Two more prayers and we're done. I pray for your spiritual life. Everything that is alive grows. If you are not growing spiritually, something is wrong. And the measure, there are two indices to measure your spiritual growth. Number one, your degree of conformity to the image of the Christ. Number two, your comprehension of the mysteries of the kingdom alongside their operation. How to make them produce consistently. I pray for you this month. As we round up this month into the next month, keys that your hands have never held spiritually, hold them right now in Jesus' name. Keys, mysteries that you have not known, or mysteries you have had and have not been able to handle, may God give it to you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Finally, this is a prayer that I pray for people with all my heart. He said, you shall anoint, listen, you shall anoint Aaron and his sons, right? And then he said, you shall take some of your honor and put upon him. How do you take honor and put upon him? Honor, the spiritual mystery that turns a man to a celebrity, not by working it. Honor is when men have the capacity to discern and reward what you represent. Hallelujah. I was coming from Abuja today and I stopped in Kaduna at a particular computer outfit just to quickly buy a laptop and proceed. And as soon as I stepped there, I entered, I saw all of them looking at me. They started jumping as if it was a crusade. Apostle Joshua Selman, I was so embarrassed. They ran, went and called their father, the owner of the place. They call it Micro Manor in Kaduna, you know. And they were jumping and they looked. They said, ah, you have been blessed by your teachings, you know. God has lifted us. You can imagine the things that have happened. And they said, which laptop are you buying and all of that? And I looked at them. I had to just run away and go out. Because I didn't want a situation where they are doing business, they carry something that is so costly and deep. Let me tell you, honor is more than money. Oh, don't be deceived. Money is very finite. Honor is when men rise up to solve your problems for you. They rise up and make it their business to see you succeed. May somebody here receive that mantle. May somebody here receive that mantle. May a pastor here receive that mantle. May a businessman receive that mantle. Strange honor. Strange honor. Strange honor. Strange honor. Strange honor. Strange honor. Hallelujah. When you are minding your business and some people are talking and say, how do we bless this lady? As if they owe you. They get up and plan. Governmental figures discussing how to lift you. And people say, what is the big deal? There is a big deal. It's a mantle. Please, I want to pray it finally. I know that our time is gone. But I want you to receive this thing. There are people here carrying it bodily. When you carry it, it speaks. See, let me tell you. The true proof of sonship is a replication of grace. A replication of grace. A replication that you are carrying something you know the devil knows and heaven knows that this is like an address. It will cause good things to look for you. I want to pray for you. Honor makes your life easy. Otherwise, you will suffer for anything. Everything. You are in trouble, you pay for it alone. There is a mystery of honor. And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. I pray for you, my God. In the name of Jesus, I pray for your people in this great house. You have placed your mantle of honor upon this house and by grace upon my life. I'm praying right now. Everyone under the sound of my voice, in a dimension you have never seen, or for those of you who have seen a measure of it in a higher dimension, receive that mantle of honor. 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 Keep standing, everybody. I want to make an altar call now. Please, no moving around. Let's honor what God is doing. No sitting down. Just 5 minutes and we're done. Thank you so much for your patience. We stretched the time quite. But I think that it's worth it. If you pay that much price and you come back with tearsome testimonies, it's a wise bargain. There are still people under the anointing. God is still doing things. And even after the service, God is still going to be touching people. But very quickly, I want to make a call. There are people outside all the overflows, any of them. And there are people following us online. You are saying, man of God, I heard you speak. And whilst you spoke, the Holy Spirit convicted my heart and told me it's time to make a commitment or a rededication. For some of you, this is your first time making a genuine decision for Jesus. Others, you have made that decision, but you are rededicating yourself. Wherever you are, please make your way to the front.
Hello. Scriptures exhort us from the book of Proverbs. It says, my son, attend to my sayings. Incline thy ears to my words. Let them not depart from thy eyes and keep them in the midst of thee. As you have listened to this message, we believe that you are going to reap the blessings thereof if you attend to these words as well. That you will keep these words in the midst of your heart. That no matter the circumstance, your eyes are going to be fixed on these words. And as you have been blessed, we will tell you to share this message. Be an evangelist by sharing to others to be blessed. And then subscribe to this channel for us, because we have loads of videos. We have loads of content that is going to make you blessed. That is going to set you on course. That is going to set you ablaze. And don't forget to like for us. Thank you.